threw over the top of the defense.
That's his 900th point of the season. This guy is now the number 9 scorer in the history of college basketball. And given any kind of a year next year like he's had this year, he could overtake Pete Maravich as the all-time leading scorer in college basketball. He's about 1,000 points behind Maravich right now.
And the man that he overtook for ninth place was Michael Brooks, who played at LaSalle.
Godbolt with a beautiful pass into Simmons. Godbolt with a pass into Simmons, and now Tisdale has picked up his first foul. So both Tisdale and Malone have opened up quickly with a foul.
Yesterday at the press conference, I listened to Wayman and said he was going to stay away in the early part of the game, and particularly the first half, try and stay away from blocking shots and keep out of foul trouble.
Neither Tisdale nor Malone have been particularly foul prone this year. Tisdale has fouled out of only 3 games out of the 35 that Oklahoma has played, as you look at Willie Simmons at the line. And Malone has fouled out of only 5 of the 31 games that Louisiana Tech has played.
Louisiana Tech, not a real good free-throwing ball club, 65.5% as a team. Simmons at 64.7, but he hits both of them.
Well, Simmons hasn't missed anything yet. He hit his only field goal attempt and 2 free throws. And Louisiana Tech and Oklahoma are tied at 4. This is Bowie. Tim McAllister, Linwood Davis, Chu Kennedy. Pretty good man-to-man defense by Louisiana Tech. No shot clock, of course, in the NCAA playoffs.
Well, they're dropping off of Linwood Davis. Smith right there, you see him, he's dropped way off, and he's going to try and protect and help inside. Linwood Davis did not shoot the ball well percentage-wise on the season, but in conference play, he shot it at about 56%.
Malone from 16 feet off the glass. Well, we've seen 2 of the big guys for Louisiana Tech get their first 2 baskets, Gary, both from outside, as you look at 36-year-old Andy Russo, the head coach of Louisiana Tech.
Andy voted coach of the year in the Southland Conference this year and also in 83.
Wayne Smith with the steal, the drive, and the bucket attempt by Allen Davis would not go, and Oklahoma dodges a bullet. And Louisiana Tech comes back with the ball, leading by 2. McAllister. Chu Kennedy. Kennedy has tied it with his 2nd basket of the ball game.
And Kennedy at 6'5", plays a lot bigger than he is. You can see his jumping ability there, and is a strong offensive rebounder.
Oklahoma, the leading scoring team in the nation, averaging 90.9, trying to force the tempo to speed up a little bit. Have they been successful, Gary, in the first 3 minutes of the ball game, do you think?
Well, I think Louisiana Tech is running just as much as Oklahoma here, and that's been their style, too, is to get up and down the court. Probably when they set up down here on offense, they might be a little bit more patient at Oklahoma on a half-court offense.
Wayne Smith, Allen Davis is number 5 with the ball. Nearest him is Linwood Davis. This is Malone from 18 feet. He's hit 2 of them. Malone from 16 and now from 18 feet.
Oklahoma went from man for man that time into a 2-3 zone, and Malone showing me greater range than I was told that he could go to. I thought he was a strong inside player, wanted to go inside basically, but he can shoot it outside.
This is Bowie. Down low to Chu Kennedy. Fall away jumper from 16 won't go. Rebounded by Godbolt.
Tough
Louisiana
shot.
Tech getting all the defensive rebounds. They haven't, I don't believe, given Oklahoma a 2nd shot yet.
You know, coming in, Oklahoma on rebound margin had almost a 7 rebound margin against their opponents to 2 to Louisiana Tech. But against Pitt and Ohio State, they out-rebounded those 2 clubs 98-58. It's almost unbelievable.
Allen Davis, Louisiana Tech leads it by 4. Well, this is a big difference because in the first game of these 2 teams, the Louisiana Tech Bulldogs never led. Now they lead it 10-6.
About the best thing that happened for the Bulldogs, I think, is to jump out to a lead here on Oklahoma after losing that ball game by 12. And I said, they know that they played bad in that ball game there, and they really felt coming in they have a great chance to win.
Wayne Smith, Allen Davis, back to Smith, and a great unselfish pass by Allen Davis results in the basket by Wayne Smith, and Louisiana Tech has doubled it. They lead the Sooners 12-6.
Wayne Smith is the assist leader, but that time Allen Davis is making a great pass to him, giving him the assist on the basket.
Linwood Davis, Anthony Bowie. This Oklahoma team has won 30 ball games. No other team in the history of the Big 8 has ever won 30 before. McAllister to the hook. First inside basket scored, and it's McAllister who gets it.
And again, that defense by Louisiana Tech has Smith dropping off Linwood Davis inside.
And, a pass there that if Malone and Simmons had connected on it, it would have been a beauty. Simmons just wasn't ready for it. It was a beautiful touch pass by Karl Malone. There's Andy Russo. There's Billy Tubbs. He is going to be, or is just about 2 weeks beyond his 50th birthday in his 11th year of college coaching.
And he, too, was coach of the year for the second straight year in the Big 8 Conference.
We've played almost 6 minutes. It is 12-8 Louisiana Tech on top of Oklahoma. The first meeting resulted in a 12-point win for Oklahoma in a game in which they forced 26 turnovers from Louisiana Tech. Wide open, McAllister. Almost tipped in by Karl Malone, but the mailman gets the rebound. He almost scored it for Oklahoma.
Bowie should have grabbed that rebound. Didn't have good control on the tip. He's all by himself. Should have grabbed the rebound, taken it down, either set back up on the offense or then taken the shot back up.
He almost handled it like a defensive rebound, Gary. Here's Allen Davis again. Got the screen for Malone. Malone's at 20 feet, gives it back to Davis. 12-8, Louisiana Tech. 14-13 to play, first half. Willie Simmons, guarded by Tisdale, down low to Wayne Smith, and he is fouled by Linwood Davis. His first foul, second on Oklahoma. And now we get our first substitute coming into the lineup for the Oklahoma Sooners. That'll be David Johnson, a Husky 6'7", 240-pound sophomore from Kansas City. We've got a timeout with 14:05 remaining to play, and our score, Louisiana Tech 12 and Oklahoma 8.
Malachi, Smithy, Bostic, Jansen.
Come on in, see the good old boys.
It's spring roundup time and the good old boys are heading great deals your way on full-size Regency 98 Luxury of the high-performance feel and style of Calais. On the Cutlass Sierra, the most popular car in America. The good old boys are rounding them up and heading them your way. So what are you waiting for?
Come on in,
Oklahoma,
see the good old boys.
Whether you're looking at capital strength, consistent growth, or earnings management, a recent independent analysis shows Founders outperforming all the bigger banks in Oklahoma City with the highest capital ratio, strongest growth, and the healthiest earnings. So when you choose a place for your money, remember, there's no safer place than Founders Bank. May Avenue at Northwest Expressway.
We're with you at Founders.
Louisiana Tech show you here how to handle a fast break. You see Wayne Smith coming down, gives the ball off to Davis, and watch the beautiful bounce pass back right by McAllister. Back to Smith. He lays it up, and a quick 2 points for the Louisiana Tech Bulldogs.
There is a closer look at Wayne Davis. Well, look at the early shooting. Louisiana Tech has done that on 5 out of 9. Oklahoma is 4 out of 11 from the field to this point, as the Louisiana Tech Bulldogs have raced out to a 12-8 lead. And their two big men, Malone and Simmons, are 3 out of 3, Gary, from outside.
Well, that's one thing. Simmons is pulling Tisdale outside, which is also going to take him off the boards. I'm sure Billy Tubbs said after the game in Oklahoma City in the all-college tournament, 38%. There's no way we can shoot that again here in the early going. They're 36%.
Adam Frank, number 22, is in the ballgame now for Louisiana Tech. That's Frank with the ball. Wayne Smith from outside. Rebounded by Bowie.
Good ball movement by the Bulldogs, though, on that particular possession. Just did not get the shot down.
Tisdale is 1 out of 2 in the early going. Wide open. Kennedy had it blocked. And a foul called on Simmons. Well, Simmons, who has 258 career blocks, almost got another one, but he got a foul also, Gary.
You can see why he's a great shot blocker here. Here's Kennedy, goes up and into him and gets the ball. Looks like gets the ball, but evidently gets him with a little bit of body. Well, here's Kennedy, and I think comes down across the head right there. And Simmons, the conference and school record holder for block shots, he has 91 this season.
And 268 for his career. There's Karl Malone, the mailman. And now Chu Kennedy. The name is actually Daryl Kennedy, a 6'5 sophomore out of Oklahoma City.
You said earlier he had a great game against Louisiana Tech back there in December. He had 21 points and 15 rebounds in that ball game.
Took up quite a slack when Tisdale had an off night, getting only 12 points and 9 rebounds.
And he was 3 for 16 shooting in that game.
Here comes the break by Louisiana Tech, and a beautiful pass inside, and we get a blocking foul, I believe, on David Johnson. We did. That'll be his first 3 on Oklahoma. If you've just joined us, Louisiana Tech leads it 12-10 as you look at David Johnson. In the first game played on the 30th of December in the finals of the All-College Tournament at Oklahoma City, Oklahoma raced to a 17-point lead at the half, and Louisiana Tech never got closer than 7 in the second half. Adam Frank, 6'1 senior out of New Orleans.
And he had a great tournament at Tulsa in those first and second round games against Pitt and Ohio State. He was 7-for-10 and 6-for-7 from the free throw line in those two ball games. Great performance by the senior.
Louisiana Tech has not missed a free throw yet. They still haven't. They are 4 out of 4. Are the Bulldogs from Ruston, Louisiana, champions of the Southland Conference, and they lead it 14-10.
Louisiana Tech been changing up their defense, giving Oklahoma a lot of different looks.
Tisdale lost the ball out of bounds. So the Oklahoma All-American has not gotten away to a winging start as you look at a fiery Billy Tubbs.
I think Oklahoma's going to have some patience coming down on offense, and the other guys on the team look for some shots. I think there's some shots there for him to be had as they're dropping tough on Tisdale inside.
Willie Bland, number 3, is in the ballgame, and Tisdale has just picked up his second foul. So Wayman Tisdale has picked up his second foul with 13 minutes and 15 seconds remaining to play, as apparently he blocked Karl Malone down along that baseline.
Trying to body check him as Malone went through, trying to post up.
Allen Davis and Robert Godbolt come back in the lineup now for Louisiana Tech. There's Davis, number 5, as Wayne Smith sits down on the bench next to Andy Russo.
You see both coaches use 7 players. That's about as many as you'll see in this ball game.
That's 14 fouls, incidentally, against Oklahoma. Louisiana Tech has 2. With the ball is Adam Frank. Now Allen Davis. We've played 7 minutes. Louisiana Tech leads by 4. Davis. Godbolt. Wouldn't go. Tisdale claims the rebound. Gets it away to Anthony Bowie.
Tisdale with that rebound. Of course, he's Oklahoma's all-time scorer and rebounder now.
A power move to the hook by David Johnson. 6'7", 240-pound sophomore from Kansas City. And it is now 14-12, Louisiana Tech by 2.
Johnson's kind of player. He's had an up-and-down year, but he seems to come and play in the big games, and there's nothing bigger than this game tonight.
Oklahoma in a zone, and Malone hits over it. That is his 3rd basket, all of them from 16 feet or further. That one was from 20 feet in the corner. Malone has 6 points, and Louisiana Tech leads it by 4.
See the drop of the defense by Louisiana Tech. They're just right back there inside. It'll be tough to get the ball in.
3-on-1. Let's see how they handle it. 2 points for Willie Bland.
Well, Louisiana Tech showing us they know how to run the basketball. They get up and down the court quick and have handled it real well, something that they didn't do in that first ball game.
They got the break that time and made something out of it. Tisdale, the great turnaround jump shooter, but he doesn't get it, and the mailman gets the rebound. It's 18-12, biggest lead of the night so far for Louisiana Tech, 6 points.
And a good job by the Bulldogs there right there, as I think they've got Tisdale pushed a little bit further out than he'd like on that turnaround jump shot.
The shot no good by Adam Frank, rebounded by McAllister. Gary, do you think Oklahoma went to the zone because of the 2 quick fouls on Tisdale, or is that just a normal change in their defense?
Well, I'm sure that could probably be possible, but they'll change the defenses too. They'll play a lot of zone.
Bowie ripples the cord from 21 feet away. It's 18-14, Louisiana Tech. You would think that a high-scoring game would favor Oklahoma. Louisiana Tech only surrendered over 74 points one time this year. That was when Oklahoma scored their 84 in beating them 84-72.
And of course, Oklahoma, the highest-scoring team in the country, averaging 90.9 points a ball game.
Malone is 4 out of 4, and none of them have come closer than 16 feet for the mailman. He is using airmail tonight. It is 20-14 in favor of the Bulldogs. This is Chu Kennedy, and a pass tipped away by Davis, but saved by McAllister.
Good job by Davis that time, playing the passing lanes.
Loose ball again. Here goes Louisiana Tech. Davis wide open. Davis for 2 more, and on the break now, Louisiana Tech has scored 4 baskets and lead it 22-14. And 4 baskets on the fast break.
Right now, turnovers are hurting Oklahoma, and they're converting those turnovers into easy baskets. 2-on-1 situations, 3-on-1.
David Johnson, a power move to the hook. And it's going to be a charging foul on Johnson. So right now, everything is going the way of the Louisiana Tech Bulldogs as Johnson gets his second foul, 5 against Oklahoma. Willie Simmons and Wayne Smith back in the ballgame for Coach Andy Russo. There's Wayne. Well, I'll tell you what, these Southland Conference champions have jumped out in just completely opposite fashion to the first ball game between these two teams.
And they're an impressive ball game or ball club. First time I've seen them play, but they've got a little bit of everything. They match up well with Oklahoma.
Against the Sooner zone now. Oklahoma dropped that about three possessions ago, the man-to-man. This one's going to be way short. Pulled down by Chu Kennedy. Under 10 minutes to go now. 22-14. Louisiana Tech with an 8-point lead. Winner advances to the Midwest Regional Final on Saturday afternoon at 1 o'clock Central Time. Wide open, Chu Kennedy from 12 feet. Kennedy has three of Oklahoma's eight baskets to this point.
Godbolt and Wayne Smith got mixed up on their defensive assignments that time. Smith was pointing to Godbolt to cover another man, and by the time they got there, they found Kennedy wide open.
Malone hasn't missed.
Beautiful.
Look at that pass.
Oh,
beautiful pass and a great hook shot by Willie Simmons. A left-handed semi-jump sky hook.
I tell you, this Malone can do it all. I'm impressed. I expect to see a great offensive player, but I'm seeing a great passer in that big guy, too.
And Anthony Bowie connects again from long range. The 6'6 junior out of Tulsa makes it 24-18. Louisiana Tech by six.
Well, Bowie, a second-team All-Big Eight performer, and he's a good clutch player for it. And he can hit the outside shot.
Louisiana Tech has never beaten Oklahoma in five previous starts, but they've never played them before outside the state of Oklahoma. Godbolt, Malone. Yes, Gary.
I was going to say a 2-3 zone. Well, that ball hit the rim right there. And that's something just like the Oklahoma likes to do with Tisdale, like to get the alley-oop pass into Malone.
Well, Simmons had it, lost it, and it goes back to Wayne Smith. He's wide open at 12 feet and doesn't get it. And Kennedy gets the rebound. Oklahoma with a chance to cut it to four. Bowie, his third shot from that same place. Bowie has hit three long-range jumpers from out of there in the left-hand guard spot. It's 24-20, Louisiana Tech by four, with 8:20 to play in the first half.
He gets someplace there. That perimeter area is where Oklahoma is going to have to go here in the early going as they really collapse inside. And both Bowie and McAllister shot the ball real well the last five ball games from outside.
He's five for five. Malone is five out of five, and all of them from outside. He has not muscled in for a single bucket yet. He hasn't missed from 16 feet or beyond. It's 26-20. 10 points put up by Karl Malone. Bowie, this time missing, and Malone grabs the rebound.
Smith did a good job there as Bowie beat him, and he went up for it instead of coming down. So many kids will foul in that situation. Bowie kind of went up for the shot, and I think hoping to draw the foul, ended up taking a bad percentage shot.
Now, Gary, is it normal to see Oklahoma stay in a zone this long?
Yes, they'll play a lot of zone half during the year. They might jump up and trap you. Sometimes they'll go to a 1-3-1 trap on a half court.
You don't think that the two fouls on the big guy were the factor in this zone?
Oh, I think that has some bearing, right, when you got Tisdale with two fouls. A lot of times early in the year, Billy Tubbs has taken Tisdale out when he picks up a quick two fouls. I don't think he can afford to do that in this game.
Simmons badly off the mark, but gets his own rebound. Misses it again, and this time it is all Chu Kennedy. And Oklahoma could cut it to four again with 7 minutes to play in the first half. Louisiana Tech has led virtually all the way. Tisdale, the turnaround jumper that is deadly.
That's the first time that Tisdale's got the ball that deep. They've done a good job of pushing him out to about 10 feet.
Tisdale is now two out of four from the field, and it is 26-22. Louisiana Tech with a four-point lead with 6:40 to go. The team out of Ruston, Louisiana, battling the team out of Norman, Oklahoma. Louisiana Tech bust up here, as they do normally when they come up here to play UTA or North Texas State within the Southland Conference. No 45-second shot clock, so you just hunt and peck as long as you want to. Godbolt, short, gets his own rebound. And it is a player control foul on Godbolt. His first three against Louisiana Tech. So we're going to have a brief cessation of hostilities with 6 minutes and 14 seconds remaining to play. There's a timeout on the court with the score, Louisiana Tech 26, Oklahoma 22.
A champion in search of the power of the glow, battling for his life against a maniac, a madman, and the heaviest hit squad ever seen.
Three times over, boy.
This is Barry Gordy's The Last Dragon, directed by Michael Schultz, rated PG-13.
Starts tomorrow at a theater near you. Tonight, for a special way to dine, it's barbecue time at the Oklahoma Line. The view and the barbecue are second to none. It's country style for everyone. Seconds on ribs, sausage, and brisket. Salads, long beans like Mom used to fix it. You know there's more. Our chicken's a delight. Our bread's baked fresh. Our prime rib's right. So you're full, but no dinner is complete without homemade ice cream. A very special treat. Tonight's the night for a special way to dine. It's barbecue time at the Oklahoma Line.
Let's see Louisiana Tech come off a play here and get out on the fast break, which they've done well in this first half. See the ball get tipped away, come out. I think it's Bland forwarding the ball in here. Good feedback here. The Godbolt, or was it? Couldn't see whether it was Godbolt or Bland that got that basket, but good ball handling.
Well, Oklahoma so far is at 10 out of 19 for their 55%. Louisiana Tech, 11 out of 23 for their 52.3%. The rebounding right now favors Louisiana Tech by 12 to 10. And there you have Billy Tubbs. Billy still jogs about 3 miles every day, although he occasionally chops on a cigar. I don't know if he has a cigar while he runs. There's the mailman, Karl Malone.
Boy, he has been impressive with the shooting outside. You got to credit Oklahoma's Bowie for keeping the Sooners in this thing. He had three outside jumpers.
Here's the big guy.
Louisiana Tech could pull this ball game out to double figures.
26-22 in favor of Louisiana Tech, getting close to the five-minute mark. Inside to David Johnson, powers it home. Johnson has come off the Oklahoma bench now to score three buckets.
And he's effective down low, and it looks like Oklahoma's going to try to go to him with Tech doubling up on Tisdale. That'll free Johnson up to go one-on-one.
This is Wayne Smith down low to Adam Frank. Frank takes it back from the big guy, Simmons. Oklahoma staying in that 2-1-2 zone. Tisdale, in case you missed it, picked up two early fouls.
Boy, there's a strong battle inside.
This one's on Malone. Malone has two. So the two big guys each have a couple of fouls apiece. Four team fouls against Louisiana Tech, five against Oklahoma.
Well, you see two physical players right here. Tisdale doing a good job of fronting him right now, trying to come over the side and get across, and Malone hooking him with the arm and holding him off, and that's where the call was made.
Well, the two fellows each have a couple of fouls apiece, Malone and Tisdale. In their first meeting, Malone scored 22 points and had 15 rebounds. Tisdale scored only 12 and had 9 rebounds. But Oklahoma won the war 84-72.
And that's a real battle inside between those two guys on both ends, positioning for offense and then going up on the glass for the rebound.
Is this sort of a matchup zone now that we're seeing from Louisiana Tech?
Yep, they've been switching defenses, and they do a good job of that, disguising things. And they've, I think because of Johnson going down inside, they've got into that matchup.
Tisdale missed the layup. Malone grabs the rebound off.
Good pass by Johnson. Tisdale just not able to convert.
It's 26-24, Louisiana Tech. Wayne Smith from 18. Jump ball, which will belong to Louisiana Tech on the alternate possession. The arrow points the way of Louisiana Tech on the alternate possession, but we're going to have a timeout with 4 minutes and 47 seconds remaining to play in the first half. As you look at Andy Russo, there's a timeout on the court. 26-24, Louisiana Tech, up by two in the Midwest Regionals.
Cold chicken you can get in a minute, but it takes all day to tenderly prepare.
Fast food that doesn't taste fast.
What do you call ribs ready like that, but that have been slow smoked over real hickory?
Fast food that doesn't taste fast.
What about made from scratch dinner rolls ready with every meal?
Fast food that doesn't taste fast.
And where is the only place you can get fast food that doesn't taste fast?
Grandy's.
Paramount Pictures presents the story of two men who struggle to be king. But only one man can unite the nation. King David, rated PG-13.
Starts Friday, March 29th at the Almaty and other theaters. Check newspaper for listings and showtimes.
This telecast is presented by authority of the NCAA, and any use of this program without written consent is prohibited. The announcers for this program have been approved and contracted by NCAA Productions. Transportation arrangements provided through Fugazi International Travel, the official travel agency of the 1985 NCAA Basketball Tournament. Gary, let's take a look at these turnovers. Now, in the first half, remember in their first meeting, Louisiana Tech turned the ball over 18 times. So far, the shoe has been on the other foot.
Well, and that hurt Oklahoma in the early going. Louisiana Tech causing some of those, forcing those turnovers, and then getting out quick on the break in the transition game and converting into easy baskets.
26-24, Louisiana Tech with a two-point lead. The champions of the Southland Conference against the champions of the Big 8 Conference. Malone is 5 for 5 from outside. Ball knocked out of bounds by Tim McAllister. It'll belong again to the blue-clad Louisiana Tech Bulldogs. Winner of this game will play the winner of the Memphis State-Boston College game, which will be a second game here tonight at Reunion Arena in Dallas, which incidentally will be the site of the 1986 Final Four here in Dallas. These teams, of course, hoping for a shot at the 1985 Final Four next week in Lexington, Kentucky.
Well, I'm impressed. That's just a little thing there. But Malone, when the ball goes inside right there, instead of looking for himself, he kicked it right out. He's a very unselfish player. They didn't get anything out of it that time. But I'm just truly impressed with that guy as a player.
4 minutes to play in the ball game in the first half. 26-24, Louisiana Tech by two. Wayne Smith. Long shot from outside. Adam Frank will not go. David Johnson grabs the rebound, and the Sooners can tie it.
Good job by Johnson coming in from the weak side and controlling the offside boards.
McAllister to Bowie. Bowie's been their best long-range shooter. They're covering up Tisdale pretty well along that baseline.
Well, McAllister's open here on the wing. They'll have to move the ball quick or else skip pass. They got a chance to get...
There it is, the alley-oop. And Tisdale gets his second alley-oop of the night, and we are tied.
And Johnson's a good passer from that point. He'll look for that pass every time into Tisdale. Tisdale tried to freeze his man as they come back from the wing to the high post and then go for the lob.
Four times the ball game has been tied now in the first half with 3:10 remaining to play. The jump hook shot put up no good. Rebounded by Johnson again. And Oklahoma can take the lead for the first time since early on. McAllister will not go. Chu Kennedy with a follow shot that is good.
A good offensive rebound. I said Kennedy get up there, go on the glass.
28-26, Oklahoma. The lead has changed hands now. That's not too many times that that's happened. But Oklahoma has it with 2:43 to go. 28-26 Sooners. Malone, his sixth shot of the night. First one that he's missed.
Ooh.
Big rebound by Tisdale.
He just sucked that out of there with one hand.
And Oklahoma gets the basket from McAllister, and the Sooners are on a roll.
That may be a key for Oklahoma. McAllister hitting the outside shot because he can loosen things up. And Oklahoma getting out on a break, not really getting the layup, but getting down on a secondary break and getting the wide open shot.
Well, let's see what the big man have done to this point. Wayman Tisdale has hit 3 out of 6 shots for his 6 points, and he has 3 rebounds. Karl Malone has hit 5 out of 6 shots and has 4 rebounds and 10 points. So almost pretty much of a standoff between the two big guys.
Well, they're two great players, and a little bit. Here's Malone going up for the shot. Watch Tisdale. Now, I think this on this great rebound. He just takes it up, cups it in one hand, brings it down, and then kicks the ball out on the outlet pass.
I think they ought to call him Windex after that one. He really wiped those boards on glass clean, doesn't he?
Bowie did a nice job in the middle there. You see him take the defense away, knew McAllister was coming late, drew the defense over to the right side, little spin, and then hit McAllister for the wide open shot.
In the first game that was played in, well, let's look at that alley-oop again. We'll tell you about that first game. Here it is again.
Well, this is something Oklahoma likes to run. You'll see now Tisdale, he'll get his man in front of him. This day doesn't get him froze there and pinned as well as normal, but then Johnson with the lob pass up around the rim, and you see Tisdale coming out, plays with a lot of enthusiasm.
6'9", 250 pounds, the only player in the history of college basketball to be named a consensus All-American as a freshman, as a sophomore, and as a junior. Now, there have been other three-time All-Americans, but no other player has ever been named consensus All-American as a freshman, sophomore, and a junior. But Wayman Tisdale has that distinction. There he is, the big guy from Tulsa, Oklahoma. Actually, I think he was born in Fort Worth, about 30 miles from here. Tisdale, with a year next year like he has had his first 3 years, could pass Pete Maravich as the leading scorer in the history of college basketball.
Here's a score from the East, Frank. Georgia Tech leads Illinois 25-18 in the first half.
Our score is 30-26, Oklahoma with 2:19 remaining to play. There's Carl with his 10 points. And now here comes Louisiana Tech back against still at Oklahoma zone. And the ball tipped away by Chu Kennedy, but it'll belong to Louisiana Tech. Louisiana Tech led by as many as 6 points, but Oklahoma has come back to reclaim the lead by four.
And Oklahoma more active in the zone right now. They're hustling and playing the zone a little tougher.
That's Allen Davis with the ball. Robert Godbolt. Davis again. Wayne Smith.
So important anymore in those zones to play those passing lanes. You can't move the ball as quick. You may have to go over the top. Slows down the rotation of the ball.
Wayne Smith shooting and missing. Godbolt with a rebound. Smith inside to Willie Simmons. Simmons had it blocked by Wayman Tisdale. And out they come on the break. What a block by Tisdale of the 6'10 Simmons hook shot.
Tisdale really asserting himself now on the defensive end and on those boards. Big rebound, big block.
Oklahoma up by four with a minute and a half to play. McAllister from 26. Wayne Smith on the rebound. It's a three-on-three break. Smith nicely off to Godbolt. Godbolt's shot would not go down, and Bowie comes back the other way. Pass inside to Johnson. Beautiful pass.
Beautiful ball handling on Oklahoma. Now Oklahoma getting out of a transition game and turning it out. It was Louisiana Tech doing that in the early part of the half.
Now for the third time tonight, Oklahoma leads it by six with a minute two to play, 32-26. Malone, beautiful pass into Wayne Smith and got the layup. Great pass. These two big guys can really pass that basketball.
They can do it all.
4 points for Wayne Smith, 32-28, 48 seconds to play in the half. Oklahoma up by four. Racehorse basketball between the nation's leading squad. Here is a steal by Allen Davis, and he is fouled by McAllister. That is team foul number six on the Sooners.
That's a good foul by McAllister. You'll see here, they're not in the one and one yet. Good steal here by Davis coming out. McAllister, he looked up the scoreboard after this, which him reach from behind, and I think makes the foul in on purpose right there. And I watched him. He looked up at the board, and I think he knew what the situation as far as fouls were concerned. Saved 2 points.
Eddie Player, a 6'3 sophomore from Gary, Indiana. Tim McAllister, all right. 32-28 with 30 seconds to play in the half. The inset in the lower right-hand portion of your screen indicates, of course, the time remaining.
A good play right here by Andy Russo. Pull the ball club out, take one shot. He got a chance to cut it down, at least not Oklahoma if they should miss, by putting up an early shot, extend the lead out to 6 points.
Well, they've spread it out pretty well. Let's see when there's the play. It is to Malone. He misses the layup. Godbolt has it. Oklahoma's going to have a chance for a shot if they hurry. 2 seconds, McAllister. Well, a four-point lead at the end of the first half for the Oklahoma Sooners over the Louisiana Tech Bulldogs. That's the end of the first half with the score, Oklahoma 32, Louisiana Tech 28. We'll be back after these messages and a local station break. This is an NCAA Productions telecast.
How about over there?
In 1958, Bob and Bill didn't need a business loan.
Okay, by me.
To get their ideas off the ground.
This is gonna be neat, yeah.
Construction financing meant using their lunch money.
Hey, let's tear it down, build it again.
When your goals move from the backyard into the business community, your banker can help.
Hey, I've got an idea. Yeah, what? Let's tear it down and build it again.
Bob.
When you mean business, you've got a financial friend, your Oklahoma banker.
It's spring cleaning time at Mathis Brothers Furniture, and it means big savings for you in every department.
With this year's spring furniture market less than 3 weeks away, Bill and I have authorized unheard-of discounts on every item in our store.
We must and will sell completely out of last year's styles and fabrics. All Sealy Posturepedic bedding is one-half price until the new models arrive.
Prices on reclining chairs by Lazy Boy have been reduced as much as one-half. We've rolled up our sleeves, and we're rolling back prices.
And we're staying open until 10 p.m. every night during spring cleaning at Mathis Brothers, 3434 West Reno.
Remember the good old days? A man stood firmly behind his beliefs. He labored hard, trained himself well, and took pride in his work. Today, that same tradition guides us at Local Federal, helping us give you the best in banking services day after day. With a strong net worth position and 21 locations, we're one of Oklahoma's leading financial institutions.
We're Local Federal.
In a word,
dependable.
Pontiac.
The editors of Road and Track call the Pontiac 6000 STE one of the world's 12 best enthusiast cars. Car and Driver called the Pontiac 6000 STE one of the 10 best cars of 1984. So why did we make it even better for 1985? Just because. the sensational 6000. Only from Pontiac.
At Hudeberg Dodge, we have one and only one ambition: to be the best. What else is there?
Venture's grand openings in Rockford, Illinois and St. Louis bring excitement and savings to every Venture store. Celebrate with savings on tropical print cap shirts. This season's hottest new looks, bold and bright, and Venture's got them. Just $6.66 for men's and women's sizes. Save on fleece crewnecks and pants, too. These colorful basics set the pace for working out or taking time off. Adult sizes now two for just $11.88 during Venture's grand opening sale.
Save at Venture. Save with style.
Well, that's the story at halftime. The Oklahoma Sooners up by four over the Louisiana Tech Bulldogs. Actually, Tech led at one point 24-16. So from that point on, Oklahoma outscored the Bulldogs 16-4, getting some key baskets from Darryl Chew Kennedy and from Wayman Tisdale, who had two of his patented alley-oops. For Louisiana Tech, they started out like a house of fire, with Karl Malone hitting his first five shots. All were perimeter shots. And his 10 points and the six by Willie Simmons represent the most by Louisiana Tech here in the first half. Kennedy has led Oklahoma scoring with 10 points. Tisdale had six. In the matter of players off the bench, Oklahoma brought only one man in off the bench. That was David Johnson, and he contributed 6 points. For Louisiana Tech, Willie Bland and Adam Frank were the only two players who came in off the bench. So at halftime, it is 32-28 Oklahoma over Louisiana Tech. We'll return with more halftime activities right after these messages.
Nothing beats the high I feel while playing a good game of basketball, or the excitement after a great day on the court. It's a real special feeling. I tell you one thing, drugs or alcohol couldn't make me feel that good. Don't let anyone tell you drugs or drinking are going to make you feel good. Take it from me, drugs just get in your way and prevent you from doing your best. What else can I say? Drugs make losers out of users.
The preceding message provided by the NCAA.
Mortgage payment, car payment, food, miscellaneous expenses, and don't forget lunch money. Now you're out of cash, but you need tires fast. What do you do?
Get a Big O Tires credit card. With a Big O Tires credit card, you can buy your tires today and pay for them later. Just come in and fill out an application. It only takes about 30 minutes to process. The Big O Tires credit card. It gives you that Big O feeling of confidence.
It's Target's Big Sale, featuring enormous savings store-wide. Save big on Coronet paper towels. Two rolls are only $1. Coronet bath tissue four packs are five for $4. Sony blank videotapes are only $5.99 each, or $3.99 after rebate. And get a Philips refund of up to $5 on any oil filter when you buy a 12-pack of Trop Arctic. Just 75 cents a quart. It's the big sale at Target.
You don't pay more for a Curtis Mathis, you get more. The best-built TVs, stereos, and video recorders in America, backed by the best warranty, our exclusive 4-year limited warranty. You get free setup and delivery, local sales and repairs, 5 locations with everything from showstopper video movies to satellite dishes, like this Curtis Mathis Entertainment Center, a complete stereo system with 25-inch color TV. Buy outright or rent to own. There's no credit check, no down payment. Come in today to Curtis Mathis.
Aging, just as important to beer as it is to wine. Aging gives beer something called balance, just the right combination of flavors and aromas. Of course, thinks that aging is so important, they age their beer longer than any other major brewer. They use the time to age out a lot of the heaviness, a lot of the bitter aftertaste you'll find in many other beers. So when you want a beer that's a little smoother, with all the spirit of a great beer, Coors is the one. Coors and Coors Light.
2-28, and I'm happy to have as my halftime guest Frank Windegger, who is the athletic director at TCU and also a member of the NCAA Division I basketball committee. And that, of course, is the committee that selects the 64 teams for this NCAA tournament. But I'd be interested to know who all makes up that committee, Frank.
Well, Gary, it's an interesting group of colleagues that I have. Really a great bunch of athletic administrators, both commissioners and athletic directors throughout the country. The names are submitted by the basketball committee or various groups to the nominating committee. The nominating committee passes on them, presents that slate to the convention to be voted on. And there's guys such as the chair of the committee this year is Vic Bubas, who's a commissioner in Sun Belt Conference. Gene Corrigan, Notre Dame. Rich House, West Virginia. Seth Dempsey from Arizona. Dave Hart, University of Missouri. And then Frank Windegger from TCU. And Dick Schultz, the University of Virginia, who'll be the chair next year. And of course, we're ably administrated from the NCAA by Tom Jernstedt and Dave Kaywood, who do yeoman duty.
Are you, as a committee, comfortable right now with this 64-team format?
Yeah, I really am. We don't no longer have the buys, and as far as I know, at least to myself or any committee member I've talked to, there's been no complaints surface at all. As we well know, Gary's a long day last week in Houston, but a great day for the basketball freaks. What a lot of great games. So, no, I don't think there's been any complaints at all about 64 tournament.
And the way you've seeded these teams seems to have worked out very accurately, because there hasn't been a whole lot of upsets.
Been very few, and you'll always have a few, but I think the regionals are really sufficing that the seeding was good and we're going to have a great national championship.
Frank, what about the teams that play in this NCAA tournament? They have a chance to take home a pretty good payday, don't they, financially?
Yes, they do. You know, the first round's about $140,000. You go into the second round, that moves up to two-something. You're into the semi of the regionals right now, which is a payday of $400,000. You get through the final four, you're up to $707,000 per team.
Frank, thank you for stopping by and being our halftime guest.
Gary, my pleasure.
We'll return with more halftime activities right after this station break.
At Hudeberg Dodge, we have one and only one ambition, to be the best. What else is there?
Why are more and more Oklahomans having Cool Temp install gorgeous Coleman garden rooms on their home? Well, we're in southwest Oklahoma City right now, and here's Mrs. Aldine Kiesel to tell you why.
Cool Temp gave me the best plans, and they gave me the best price, and I felt that they guaranteed their work, and they certainly have stood by their guarantee.
Thanks, Mrs. Kiesel. You call Cool Temp today if you want a gorgeous Coleman garden room. Call Cool Temp at 232-3235.
Time score at the Midwest Regionals at Reunion Arena, Oklahoma, leading Louisiana Tech by a score of 32-28. Well, as Gary and Frank Windegger were talking about a moment ago, of course, there is other NCAA action. So we're going to kind of take you around the country. And, Gary, have you comment on these? Georgetown and Loyola will play the second game tonight. What do you look for there?
Well, Loyola with 19 straight wins. I think they have to really shoot the ball outside well if they got any chance against Georgetown.
I believe we had an early score on that Illinois-Georgia Tech game. Who was leading that one, Gary? Do you
Georgia
remember?
Tech was up on that one. I think it was 25-18, and should be a great battle of guards in that one, Bruce Douglas and Mark Price.
All right, let's move on now past the East Regional to the Southeast Regional in Birmingham, Alabama. Villanova and Maryland. There we've got the Big East against the ACC.
And you got the Cinderella team with Sonny Smith, Auburn against the master down there, Dean Smith, North Carolina.
Well, that should produce an outstanding regional. That'll come on Sunday afternoon, I believe, will it not? All right, let's move ahead now and take a look at the Midwest Regional. Of course, our game here tonight, 32-28 in favor of Oklahoma at halftime. And then it'll be Boston College against Memphis State. And right now, Boston College, with 10 losses, might be the Cinderella team of the tournament.
Well, along with Auburn, and I think it'll be Boston College's quickness against the size of Memphis State inside.
And finally, we have the West Regional, which is being played at Denver, Colorado this weekend. St. John's against Kentucky. What tradition in that game?
And Kentucky, I'm sure, would like to sneak in there and get home to Lexington for that Final Four.
And North Carolina State against Alabama.
Alabama's been playing great defense, but North Carolina State with a couple of holdovers, Charles McQueen from that championship team.
Well, we're down to the Sweet 16, and it, of course, will be the Final Four with the road to Lexington, culminating in the national championships on the first day of April. That's our halftime score, with Oklahoma leading Louisiana Tech 32-28. We'll return for the second half after these messages. This is an NCAA Productions telecast.
I don't like to see an official that is seen during the game. And I think a good official, you don't really notice that official. He's out there or she's out there doing the job, controlling the game, keeping the kids in line, and the kids are playing the game. The officials don't play the game. Those kids out there, they work every single day. And I think every time I take the floor, that I want to be as good as they are, because I think they're awfully good, and I think that the officiating has got to stay up with the athletes.
You got red, green, white.
I enjoy the game, and I enjoy the association with young people, since it is my profession as an educator, and I feel like as an official, it's a profession too. You've got to be a level-headed person, you know, a person that can be able to listen and be able to make a judgment or some type of an answer to whatever occurred on the floor.
The preceding message provided by the NCAA.
If there's one thing chicken lovers can agree on, it's
fried,
baked,
with dumplings.
Variety. So choose from deep fried, baked chicken with dressing, or chicken with dumplings. Plus salad, vegetable, beverage, and roll for just $3.59 during FIRST Chicken Choices Time. And discover something chicken lovers can agree on.
FIRST. For chicken.
FIRST Cafeteria. Making up your mind is half the fun.
Newsline 9 at 6 and 10. Oklahoma City's leading team of professionals bring you the best in news, weather, and sports coverage every day. Oklahomans rely on the Newsline 9 team. We bring you extensive news coverage that you can depend on. Oklahoma's only pilot reporter provides you with up-to-the-minute news throughout the state. Newsline 9, a dedicated anchor team bringing you the best in news, weather, and sports coverage. Weekdays at 6 and 10, only on Newsline 9.
Outdoor in Buffalo,
a little shy in Cheyenne,
in a broken bone,
out of cash in Ketchikan.
If you've got SESM Cirrus, your money's now nearby. Day or night, we'll reunite you with your cash supply. Ain't no fun in Fun City when your funds are running low. But with SESM Cirrus, you can now get cash to go.
With the SES card, your money's nearby nationwide at the Cirrus sign.
Spend the day having fun at Arbuckle Wilderness in the beautiful Arbuckle Mountains, where you'll meet over 2,000 exotic animals that you can pet and feed from your own car. And now you can enjoy $4 worth of extra attractions free with your regular admission ticket. There's always something new. It's fun. It's exciting. It's Arbuckle Wilderness.
Come feed the animals at Arbuckle Wilderness. The animals are waiting for you.
Off I-35 south of Davis, Oklahoma.
It's the 1985 NCAA Basketball Championships. From Reunion Arena in Dallas, Texas, it's the Louisiana Tech Bulldogs versus the Oklahoma Sooners.
There are those who believe that the terror of Jason is buried forever. They're wrong. Friday the 13th, part 5, A New Beginning. Rated R.
Starts tomorrow at selected theaters in Oklahoma City. Check your newspaper for listings and showtimes.
Well, Gary, we know the score is Oklahoma 32, Louisiana Tech 28. Let's take a quick look and see what happened statistically in the first half. As far as the shooting is concerned, Oklahoma outshooting Louisiana Tech 53-37%. And that reversed late in the first half, of course, when Oklahoma had that 16-4 run.
I think Louisiana Tech, the zone bothered them. Oklahoma got more aggressive in the zone. Louisiana Tech couldn't get the shot down, and Oklahoma was then able to run out and got some wide open shots. Rebounding, Louisiana Tech was sweeping the boards early, but Oklahoma's come back and has a three-rebound edge there. And both clubs have played well for the pace of the game on turnovers.
Well, Malone leads the scoring for Louisiana Tech with 10. Simmons has given 6. And for Oklahoma, Kennedy's got 10. Tisdale has 6. So we're ready to go in the second half with McAllister throwing the ball in for Oklahoma. They try to get it in a hurry, and Godbold intercepts it, and then it's knocked out of bounds. It'll belong to Oklahoma, to Louisiana Tech. You know, Gary, one of the things looking at the individual scoring, as you look at Andy Russo, is the fact that Robert Godbolt was shut out completely in the first half. You know, he scored 17 in Louisiana Tech's win over Pitt and has not been a factor here in the first half.
And he's a guy that, during their conference season, shot almost 70% from the field and is averaging in double figures, just a little over 10.
Missed all three of his first half shots. Here's Simmons with a hook shot, and Simmons starts out with that hook shot. That's his sixth point of the night. Or his eighth, rather, his third basket. It's 32-30 Oklahoma. Karl Malone hit five baskets in the first half, all from way outside. And Bowie takes it to the hook.
Strong move by Bowie there. Bowie saw the opening right there. The defense had their head and eyes turned away from him, and then he did a good job as he recovered and hit the ball, pumped it once, and got it up off the glass.
Oklahoma started out the ball game in a man-to-man after Tisdale picked up his second foul. They went to that 2-1-2 zone, and they've been with it all the way. 34-30, Oklahoma by four.
In that zone, I noticed Kennedy respecting Malone a little bit more. He was out tight on him against that zone.
The jumper would not go for Allen Davis, and Oklahoma on the run. McAllister. David Johnson, who came off the bench to score six, and Tisdale gets it inside, and you just don't stop him when he does that. Tisdale, and he's fouled by Simmons. That's eight for Tisdale, and against Simmons, his second foul.
Well, look out, Tisdale. Look how deep he is right here. And he's in the lane, comes out to get the pass, and they've done a good job, for most part, of forcing him out of there. That time he gets it down low. David Johnson with a good pass, and Simmons whacks him across the arm. Tisdale to the line, a chance to pick up a three-point play.
We really haven't had many free throws shot in the ballgame. Louisiana Tech hit four out of four in the first half. Oklahoma now is three out of four. So free throws have not been much of a factor in the ballgame. It's 37-30. Biggest lead of the night now for Oklahoma. 7 points. First time Sooners have led by that many. Beautiful pass from Malone to Simmons. He dropped it and missed it and got it. And who got the foul? Was it Tisdale? If it is, it's his third. I believe it is. Boy, Tisdale laid off of him until he just couldn't lay off of him anymore.
Simmons doing a great job of staying with it. He lost control of the ball, but up twice, third time, and finally gets fouled.
I believe it may be on Kennedy rather than on Tisdale. Yeah, I believe it is. It is Kennedy's first, not Tisdale's third. So it is on Chu Kennedy and not Wayman Tisdale. Well, so far, Louisiana Tech has not missed a free throw. They're five out of five, three of those by Simmons.
Good look at Simmons there. Was the most valuable player in the Wendy's Classic tournament, which included Louisville and Western Kentucky. Has played exceptionally well. They say he has just come from nowhere since he was a freshman. Came in there uncoordinated, didn't know much about basketball, and just made remarkable improvement.
Oklahoma by five, and here goes Bowie to the hoop again, and we have a foul on the floor, I believe, on Allen Davis. The 6'2 senior from Monroe, Louisiana, committing his first foul. We didn't really have very many fouls in the first half. That was not any problem for either team. 16 fouls against Oklahoma and four against the Bulldogs in the first half. Bowie, Tisdale from 12. Tisdale. Now Tisdale has 11 points, five of them in the first minute and 45 seconds of the second half.
And that's his shot. You just cannot afford to give him that shot on the baseline. He's a great turnaround jump shooter.
Godbolt, way short again. David Johnson. Godbolt has not been able to buy a bucket. Tisdale, so far tonight, he's 0 for 5.
At last play, Tisdale did a good job of jamming Godbolt and staying away from the foul. Kept his hands out of the play, did not reach or grab.
This is Godbolt feeding it off to Wayne Smith from 12 feet. And I believe McAllister got him. McAllister picks up his second foul. Well, already we've had five fouls in the first 2 minutes and 11 seconds of the second half. We played the entire first 20 minutes of the ball game and had only 10 fouls called.
Here's coming out Tech on the break, getting it down quick, and Smith goes up. You see McAllister coming across, gets him on the arm. Probably should have turned Smith loose right there. Smith is probably the poorest of their guards and outside shooters.
Louisiana Tech is still perfect from the free throw line. And Smith keeps them that way. They are 8 out of 8 at the stripe. It's 39-34 Sooners, 17:49 to go.
Smith's value to this club really is as a team leader. Holds all the career assist mark for Louisiana Tech and runs the ball club. Probably can do more damage than lose him, they tell me, than any other player.
Great feed from Bowie to Chu Kennedy. Oklahoma has not missed. They're 4 out of 4 here in the second half and lead it now by 7 again, 41-34. Godbolt missing his sixth shot of the night. Tisdale windexes the boards. Oklahoma with a chance to go up by nine. Smith knocks it out of bounds. Sooners have not missed, hitting their first four shots in the second half. Two by Tisdale, one by Bowie, and one by Kennedy. First game resulted in a 12-point Oklahoma victory. Sooners are 30-5. Louisiana Tech is 29-2. And there's a foul on Allen Davis, his second, third against the Bulldogs.
Good job by McAllister that time protecting the ball. You saw a good shot there of Davis as he tried to come from behind, reach behind, and normally you'll get caught for that foul.
Andy Russo, whose Louisiana Tech team has won 13 in a row and 37 out of their last 40. And there's Billy Tubbs, whose ball club has won 8 in a row and 20 out of their last 21.
Billy Tubbs with 20 wins in 6 of his last 7 years of coaching.
Simmons has just picked up his third personal foul on that attempt to block Tisdale's shot. So Simmons becomes the first player to pick up three fouls, and the shot blocker par excellence has picked up three for Louisiana Tech.
Tisdale seeing the ball now a lot more in this early part of the second half than he did in the first half. He only had 6 shots up at the hoop in that first half.
All right, and now we're going to get a substitute as Godbolt comes out of the lineup. And Willie Bland back in for Louisiana Tech. Gary, you mentioned Tisdale seeing the ball a lot more now. Why? Why is that happening?
I think they've been isolating on the one side, getting him down low. He's moved, coming on the baseline and rotating sides.
There you see Robert Godbolt.
The outside shooting has loosened up the defense a little bit, where they haven't been able to sag quite as deep or get there as quick.
Well, the only thing Tisdale has not been able to do tonight is shoot free throws. He's 1 out of 4. It's 41-34 Oklahoma, 17 minutes to play in the ball game. Davis, short. Kennedy gets the rebound. Sooners on the run, 3-on-1. McAllister gets the 2. Oklahoma had the numbers, 3-on-1, and McAllister got the bucket. And the Sooners have their first 9-point lead of the ball game with 16:40 to go.
And that's what Oklahoma likes to do. They like to get out and run.
Oklahoma is a team that can score 10 or 12 points in a hurry, but they can also give up 6 or 8 points right back in a hurry. Simmons with a hook shot missing, and McAllister gets the rebound.
Bulldogs have a tough luck inside around the hoop. They've had several baskets in and out, and a couple times where they lost control of the ball. I think back to the first half, they had a couple in there like that. Oh, great.
Simmons
ball.
Has just picked up his fourth foul, blocking the shot, but getting his fourth foul. Well, Andy Russo's ball club has got a problem now. Let's look at it again.
Well, Simmons, a great shot blocker. You see Kennedy only 6'5", but he'll challenge anybody inside. His great leaping ability. Simmons coming out right there, gets the ball, but also gets a piece of Kennedy and picks up a crucial fourth foul.
Godbolt will come back in to replace Simmons, and Louisiana Tech is going to call a timeout. So the 6'10 shot blocker has picked up his fourth foul with 16:16 remaining to play. Louisiana Tech is only 1 out of 7 in the second half. There's a timeout on the court with a score. Oklahoma 43, Louisiana Tech 34.
Get a piece of the power.
Come get it. The lowest interest rate in town. Only 8.8% on any new Nissan truck.
A Nissan power machine.
Save over $600 in interest on the regular bed. At only $59.99, it's a great deal. With 8.8, it's even better. See the full line of Nissan trucks. Take your choice. 8.8 could save you up to $1,500 in interest alone. Only from your Nissan power team. See Jackie Cooper in Edmond. Frazier on Southeast 74th in Oklahoma City. Ken's in Midwest City. Northwest in Bethany. Wayne Buck in Clinton. And Cannon Dotson in Ponca City.
Nissan power now!
8.8 for a limited time. Only from your Nissan power team. It's awesome.
Get a piece of the power from the Nissan Power Team.
Louisiana Tech was out running in the first half, and in the second half has been the Oklahoma Sooners, and you'll see how they get the job done here as Kennedy will come up with the loose ball, kick it out, McAllister to the wing. Tisdale, a good job of getting it back. Good defense there by Smith as he covers up the wingman, but McAllister takes the little jumper and gets it down for an easy two.
Well, let's take a look at the field goal percentage this half. Louisiana Tech 1 out of 7, Oklahoma 4 out of 4. And as we watch Kennedy at the free throw line, Gary, I'm reminded of the fact that Karl Malone, the mailman, who was 5 out of 6 from the field in the first half, has not touched the ball for Louisiana Tech in the first 4 minutes of the second half.
And It's just vice versa for Oklahoma, where we said that Tisdale has been getting his hands on the ball, and Malone's going to have to get that ball in his hands. But Oklahoma zone has been doing a good job of shutting the ball off inside, and they've been playing tighter on Malone when he goes out to the wing. They've respected him after hitting those five outside shots.
Oklahoma up by 10. There's Malone's first shot of the second half, and it is tipped up once by Godbold. He won't go. Here's Malone on Tisdale. Malone gets his 12th point of the ball game, his first two of the second half.
Boy, that was Powder City right there by Malone. And Tisdale smart, keeping his hands out of there, just getting his body in good position, giving him the basket, because Tisdale is more valuable to Oklahoma on that floor, even though he might give up a basket like that here in the early part of the second half.
Sooners over the Bulldogs by 8. We've got 15 and a half minutes to go. McAllister shooting and missing. It'll belong to Louisiana Tech. And I believe David Johnson, or was Chu Kennedy that went down. Here's Malone's basket again.
Well, Malone was all outside in the first half, but watch him here. Power takes a quick dribble, exceptionally quick dribble, and Tisdale doing a good job, as you say, keeping his hands out of there and avoiding the foul and maybe a three-point opportunity and picking up his third.
Both Malone and Tisdale playing with two fouls. They both picked him up early. A basket here would cut it down to a six-point lead. Godbolt missing again. Kennedy got the rebound, and we got a foul inside on David Johnson of Oklahoma. His third. But Godbolt misses his seventh shot of the night. He's 0 for 7. Billy Tubbs, hard time understanding that one. That was away from the ball, Gary.
Well, David Johnson, a big guy. Watch here, Malone and Johnson going up, and you see Johnson, Malone actually hooked him and pulled him down, but the foul was committed first by Johnson as he was pushing him out.
And he becomes the first Oklahoma player to pick up three fouls. 44-36 in favor of the Sooners. 15-17 remaining to play in the ballgame. Oh, a pass thrown from Willie Bland right into the hands of Oklahoma.
And again, Tisdale playing really smart right now on the defense end. He went over and shut it off, kept his hands out of there, staying away from that foul, and caused the turnover.
Halftime score, Georgia Tech and Illinois tied at 29. McAllister inside. Malone gets the rebound. Again, in the East Regional, Georgia Tech and Illinois are tied at halftime, 29 apiece. Louisiana Tech down by 8. Allen Davis to Wayne Smith. Davis again inside to Malone. Big fella put it on the floor, and Kennedy blocked it. If Malone had not put it on the floor and taken it to the hoop, he might have had the basket.
Now Malone's working down deep inside right now, and you see the big guy here. Tisdale coming out, makes a grab for the interception, can't get it, but a great save by Kennedy. As we said, he's a great leaper.
Here goes Bowie on the steal. That may set Oklahoma on fire. They're up by 10 with 14 and a half minutes to go as the 6'6 junior from Tulsa came up with a tremendous steal.
Now Bowie, a two-time junior college All-American out of Seminole Junior College.
Great pass from Malone again inside to Willie Bland. And we've got a little bit of a mix-up going on inside. I believe involving Bowie and Willie Bland. Now they exchange high fives and everything's all right again.
Kennedy, as you see, picking up his personal foul, smiling here, down deep. Good pass, drop off, good read as he took that high pass. You see Kennedy coming across, gets him, and almost looked like he was going to get hurt as he went down hard.
Willie Bland will try to keep a free throw streak alive that has seen Louisiana Tech hit 8 out of 8, 9 out of 9. It is 46-37, Oklahoma, with 14:24 to go.
You see Bland's scoring average. He's got to be one of the most productive guys coming off the bench. He's a sixth man, only plays 22 minutes a game. You see his average, plus he gets almost 5 rebounds a game.
Well, the Bulldogs have still not missed from the line. They are 10 out of 10 at the stripe, but they're down by 8. 40, and here is a steal. Coming right back the other way by Bland, but did he kick it?
I think he called a kick.
The ball was kicked.
That's nothing new for... That was Bland. He leads the club in steals.
There's Andy Russo. He'll be 37 years old in the month of May. Former assistant at University of Texas at El Paso to Don Haskins. Oklahoma trying to go back up by 10. David Johnson is fouled, and I believe Malone has just picked up his third.
That was a nice pass from Bowie to Johnson. I don't know if we'll catch it right here as they reverse the ball, come around. Watch this pass. He takes it and gets it away from the defensive man. See defensive man Bland going to it, but he leads it out ahead of there, and Johnson goes and gets the ball. That was important right there. And Johnson out of the line for a couple free throws.
That foul is on Willie Bland, his first, not on Malone. Six against the team. There's Willie Bland, the junior out of New Orleans. David Johnson at the free throw line is just up the margin to nine. Johnson hits a pair. He has 8 points off the Oklahoma bench, and the Sooners are back up by 10 with 14 minutes to play.
You said Johnson's an up-and-down player. He only had 5 points in the two games at Tulsa, and they're all in the one game, so he's come back here with eight.
Nice outside jumper by Allen Davis. That is only the third basket here in the second half by Louisiana Tech. And they are down by eight. They were down by four at halftime. They've kept themselves in the ball game at the free throw line here the second half.
Well, I think some of that outside shooting between Davis and Smith, maybe Bland, they're going to have to hit some of those outside perimeter shots to loosen it up.
Kennedy wide open for his 15th point of the night.
Kennedy had a big game the last time these two teams played, and he made a good move there. He could feel the pressure from behind when he took that pass. Again, a good pass that freed him up on the baseline. Instead of taking the ball to the basket, probably getting it blocked or stuffed, he just took the little jumper.
Great Malone. Pass. Malone gets a pass, and he's fouled inside. Foul, I believe, on Kennedy, and that would be his third. Let's look at that sequence again.
Well, there's some good ball movement. And unselfish teams passing the ball. You see it coming to Malone, back up underneath. Ball get kicked out. Watch here. Off the jump. He feeds it right back inside. Takes it up strong. And who is it? Kennedy that gets called for the foul?
That's his third. He and David Johnson have three. That is five against Oklahoma as a team. 13 minutes and 12 seconds to play. 50 to 40. Oklahoma by 10. And another great outside shot by Allen Davis, who has hit two from the parking lot.
Well, and Davis, a streak shooter, he has that good 20-foot range, and that shot's open and available to Louisiana Tech against the zone of Oklahoma.
Tisdale gets it down low on the blocks after Malone had really intimidated McAllister, and Tisdale now has 13 points, and the Sooners are back up by 10. Louisiana Tech can get it down to 10, and then Oklahoma are down to 8, and Oklahoma puts it back to 10.
Well, that really hurts when you come down there and score, make a good play, and then Oklahoma comes down, and just in the matter of 7 or 8 seconds, just boom, hits you right back with a quick one.
Allen Davis is red hot. What a play under the basket by the 6'2 senior from Monroe. That was a shot that was unbelievable. He now has three buckets in a row. And coming right back is Bowie. Well, Bowie now has 12.
He's one of the most solid junior college players I've ever seen coming in his first year. He's under control, plays good, and he likes to have the ball in tough situations.
Foul call down along the baseline. Might have been on Kennedy. It is, and that's his fourth.
When this is a key foul, because Kennedy has played very, very well, not only offensively, but on the boards, made some blocks. Here comes Tisdale right in here.
Yeah, they called it on Tisdale.
It's got to be on Tisdale.
So that's three on Tisdale instead of four on Kennedy. And now team foul-wise, that's six against Oklahoma. So Tisdale has three fouls. Willie Simmons is on the Louisiana Tech bench with four. It is Oklahoma up by 10. Inside for the nice move by Willie Bland. 6'5 junior out of New Orleans.
And Louisiana Tech just got to pound it inside right now as much as they can in his zone. You saw Tisdale, he just laid off and give him the shot. He's afraid of picking up that four.
Well, with Tisdale and with Kennedy with three fouls apiece, Oklahoma's vulnerable inside, but now Malone has picked up his third. And that is team foul number seven against Louisiana Tech. So Oklahoma will go to the stripe to shoot 1-1.
You see Louisiana Tech, they're pressuring out hard on the ball. Now, when they do that, that opens up Tisdale inside, and Malone reaching across looked like maybe it could have been either Davis or Malone. Let's watch. Davis looks like he gets a piece, but then Malone, as he takes it up strong, catches him across the arm. And Tisdale seeing the ball a lot of times here in the second half.
Tisdale shooting and missing, and the loose ball picked up by Oklahoma, David Johnson. Gallister, Bowie, Kennedy, Chu Kennedy. He now has 17 points for the ball game.
And he's another guy that shot the ball exceptionally well during the last part of the season in conference play. He shoots at 52% from the field, but during that stretch of conference play, he shot almost 58%.
There is Robert Gottbold's first basket of the night. He missed his first seven shots, connects on his eighth. It's now 56-48 Oklahoma. No harm, no foul.
Well, Malone, Godbolt's inability to hit has hurt the Bulldogs. He's probably been their most consistent player, and he's been in double figures 19 out of 31 games, so they miss his offense.
There goes Bowie again, and Tisdale missing from point-blank range. Tisdale missed it from point-blank range.
No, I think why he missed that basket, it looked like that he was second-guessing himself, that he was going to go for the stuff and changed his mind. Here's Bowie, and watch Tisdale now. He goes up, and it looks like that I thought he was going to jam it. Thought he maybe was too far out, and then tried to lay it in, hit the back of the rim, and came off.
Live action again. The attempted pass by Smith. Here's the fast break. McAllister the other way. Missed it. Rebounded by Allen Davis. 56-48, Oklahoma. Godbolt misses again, and Kennedy gets the rebound.
Well, the Bulldogs couldn't take advantage because Oklahoma blew a cinch two right there as Tisdale really did a great job of kicking out on the fast break.
56 Oklahoma, 48 Louisiana Tech, 10:25 remaining to play. Winner plays on Saturday at 1 o'clock Central Time for the NCAA Midwest Regional Championship. We got a foul before the shot. It may be on Malone.
Right, and Oklahoma doing a good job of swinging the ball right now. Tisdale holding his position, coming late, and Karl Malone hustling to get shape on him, but can't quite get there in time.
That is correct, incidentally. That is the third foul on Malone. That foul a few minutes ago was charged to Allen Davis and not Malone. So Tisdale and Malone each have three fouls apiece. Tisdale is only one out of five at the line tonight. One out of six. Godbolt claiming the rebound. Allen Davis. Godbolt waited for Tisdale to go up and still missed the layup. And Robert Godbolt has not been able to get the ball to go down tonight.
We've got a foul call. I think it must be Kennedy's complaining to Hank Nickel right there on the call. Tried to get his hands in there and make a steal.
Well, that is four on Kennedy. And now that's seven on Oklahoma, so Louisiana Tech will be at the line. And Chu Kennedy has picked up his fourth foul. He leads all scorers with 17 points. And now he'll be replaced by Linwood Davis, the 5'11 junior out of Washington, D.C., who is a starting guard. And Kennedy unhappy about that fourth call. Sits down by Tommy Tubbs, the son of Coach Billy Tubbs, who is immediately to his right there. Back at the free throw line is Willie Bland shooting the 1-1. And again, Louisiana Tech is 10 out of 10 at the stripe tonight. They've not missed a free throw yet. And they came into this ball game shooting only 65% as a team. Here's Andy Russo. 56-49. 56-50, and it's 12 out of 12 for Louisiana Tech at the stripe. With 10 minutes to play, it is Oklahoma by six. They were up by four at halftime. Oh, a player control foul against Oklahoma. Linwood Davis picks up the player control foul. I believe they tried to get a timeout, Gary, and did not get it.
Well, that's just one. Let's look at right here. They catch it in. I think the guy out of bounds is trying to call timeout. Get the double team. Davis here, just one-on-one, and no reason really to come over the top as the trap had left him, and he gets called for the offensive foul.
A basket here makes it a four-point ball game with 10 minutes to play. Inside to Godbolt. Fall away. Jumper. Good. Godbolt. Louisiana Tech has cut it down to four with 9:53 to play. Here goes Bowie. Out of bounds, off of Malone.
Here's moments ago as you see Johnson trying to get it in. You'll see him right here. He's having trouble. Now he tries to motion timeout, but the count, if it gets to four, cannot get the timeout.
We have a timeout on the court. 9:47 remaining to play. Oklahoma by four, 56-52. We'll be right back.
More and more Oklahomans are calling Cool Temp to install these gorgeous Coleman garden rooms. Whether you're looking for quality or price, regardless, you're going to find your best buy with Cool Temp. Mrs. Bob Reed is very happy with her Coleman garden room from Cool Temp.
We wanted to add on to our home to have a comfortable room where we could have light, where we could have a spa, and we found the most reliable people in the world to put it on for us, Cool Temp.
If you want a gorgeous Coleman garden room, you call Cool Temp today at 232-3235.
It's Penn Square Mall's 25th anniversary, and you're invited to register for over $10,000 in prizes. You could be one of 25 winners of a $100 gift certificate, or win a fabulous trip for two to Hawaii, stay 6 nights and 7 days in a beautiful beachfront hotel, or win the grand prize, a complete 14-foot family ski boat with a Force 50 motor, trailer, and skis, all from Andy's Marine in Oklahoma City. Cut out your entry blank from the newspaper and bring it to any store at Penn Square Mall, the center of the city.
Well, that familiar face that you saw just a moment ago before we had our last time out belonged to the highly successful coach of the Memphis State Tigers, Dana Kirk, whose 29-3 team will play Boston College in the second game here tonight at Reunion Arena. Well, Gary, it's 56-52, and Oklahoma cost themselves here by not getting a timeout.
Well, you can see David Johnson trying to call it, but again, I said, if you do not get it called by the 4-second count, then that official will not give it to you.
Halftime score at Providence, Rhode Island, 29-29, Georgia Tech and Illinois at halftime. Well, there's not a whole lot to choose from, is there? 6 out of 10 from each guy. But the big difference to me, Gary, is that most of that production by Tisdale has been in the second half. Most of Malone's was in the first half. Here we go. Oklahoma up by 4 with the ball. 9:45 remaining. Winner plays the winner of the Memphis State-Boston College game on Saturday afternoon to see who goes to Lexington. Here's the steal by Willie Bland. A basket here makes it a two-point ball game. Smith loses it out of bounds.
What a bad break for the Bulldogs. Bland, an exceptional defensive player, made the steal coming down, and this is a basket they really needed to really put the pressure on Oklahoma. Good job there of sidestepping on the dribble pass. I think Smith right here just moved away, moved his eyes away from the ball, tried to react and make the play too quick before he caught the ball.
9 minutes, 20 seconds to go. Oklahoma 56, Louisiana Tech 52. Sooners with the ball. Going for their ninth straight win and their 21st out of their last 22. Tisdale, his Sunday shot wouldn't go, but Johnson tips it in.
There's Johnson. We say he's always tough in the big games, and coming through there, he's got the strength and the bulk inside to get on that offensive glass.
That is 10 points off the bench for Johnson. And Tisdale has now picked up his fourth foul.
And I'm surprised right there. Tisdale's been laying off real well, trying to keep out of foul trouble. And here he goes for the block and picks up his fourth. That could be crucial to the Sooners.
With 9 minutes and 2 seconds to play, Chu Kennedy is going to come back in, and Tisdale is going to sit down. So it's going to be Kennedy with four fouls, replacing Tisdale with four fouls. Darryl Kennedy, a 6'5 sophomore out of Oklahoma City, who has 17 points and leads all scorers in the ballgame, replacing the All-American from Oklahoma, Wayman Tisdale, who sits down with 13 points. Willie Bland, and that is the first free throw missed tonight by Louisiana Tech. After hitting their first 12 in a row, the Bulldogs miss. 58-52, Oklahoma by 6.
I don't think it's Oklahoma style to hold the ball. You wonder about maybe with Tisdale out with four fouls, and they might control and try and run some clock or bide some time, run some minutes off that clock with Tisdale sitting out with those four fouls.
But well, Malone just tipped that one in, and it's 58-54 as Malone gets his 14th point of the night. It is now a four-point Oklahoma lead. Sooners with the ball. 8 minutes and 38 seconds remaining. 58-54. Oklahoma in front by 4. Sooners trying to duplicate an earlier season victory over this ball club. As McAllister doesn't get it, but he's jammed home. Bowie, I believe. It was Anthony Bowie.
What a follow shot by Bowie, and a crucial basket for Oklahoma as Louisiana Tech has really been making a run at him here in the last few minutes.
Malone working on a smaller man inside, doesn't get it. And I think McAllister may have gotten him.
No, either that or Johnson. I think the way Johnson shook his head, I think he may have been the one, number 55.
And against Johnson, that is his fourth foul. So Johnson, Tisdale, and Chu Kennedy all playing now with four fouls. And the mailman, Karl Malone, the 6'9 junior from Summerfield, Louisiana, at the line. He has 14 points. This is his first free throw effort of the night.
And Oklahoma with a real small lineup in that on the floor right now.
And after hitting their first 12 free throws in a row, Louisiana Tech has now missed 3 in a row. They were 12 out of 12, and then Bland missed a couple, and now Malone has missed one. 60-54, Oklahoma. 8 minutes, 11 seconds left to play. 4 in a row they missed, but they get the ball back from Bland. So just as they did a moment ago, and here's Malone inside with a nice pass, loose ball. If it's a jump ball, it'll belong to Louisiana Tech, but it isn't. Oklahoma comes up with it. Under 8 minutes to play, Sooners by six. This is Linwood Davis. Johnson trying to power inside, does so. Malone with a loose ball. They've got a man open, Bland, but he couldn't control it. For the second time on a fast break opportunity, that one not quite as good a chance, but again, Louisiana Tech could not handle the break.
We lost some great opportunities to score baskets. A good lead pass right here. Bland takes it. Again, let's see his head there. He moved away. When he come down, did not quite have his hands on the basketball. Watch it again, if we can see. Goes up high. Can't see it as well from that angle, but he took his eyes off the basketball again. Over-anxious, trying to get what looked like it'd be a cinch two and lose the basket.
Live action again. Oklahoma up by six. 7.5 minutes to play. 60-54. This is McAllister. Now Bowie. Linwood Davis. Down low to Johnson. Covered up by Malone and Davis. Well, you wouldn't think the nation's leading team very generally used the stall game at all, did they, Barry?
No, but I don't think it's too bad an idea right now. The foul trouble they're in and their big man Tisdale sitting out.
Rodbolt again. The long pass. This time to Davis. Davis has the ball knocked out of his hands. It'll belong to Louisiana Tech. But that is three fast break opportunities that they've not been able to convert into baskets.
Right, and a good save by that little guy right there, Linwood Davis. He got his hand in there and...
Well, Simmons and Malone for Oklahoma. Actually, I think we got those backwards.
Got those reversed,
yeah,
right.
It should be Louisiana Tech on the right, Oklahoma on the left. And the ball will belong to Oklahoma. The foul trouble, Kennedy's got four, Tisdale four, and Johnson four for Oklahoma. For Louisiana Tech, Simmons has four fouls, and Malone has three.
This is the same problem that Coach Andy Russo, there you're looking at Andy right now, said they had in Oklahoma City against this ball club, was turning the ball over on the offensive end, either on the break or after they
here they go to the
press.
Four corners, Gary. Four corners. Oklahoma now with three players with foul trouble, Gary, and they've used only six players in the ball game. Oklahoma has used only one guy off the bench, and yet they've got three players with four fouls. 6 minutes, 38 seconds to go. Billy Tubbs, Coach of the Year in 1984, 1985 in the Big 8 Conference. His Sooners with a lot of foul trouble, and here goes Kennedy inside for the basket. 19 points for Kennedy. Big basket puts Oklahoma up by eight.
And I think it's a smart move by Billy Tubbs in Oklahoma. They got the small lineup in there. They're in foul trouble quick. They can spread it out, use their quickness, and then they're going to try to score off of it, too, and not just hold the basketball.
Allen Davis now has 12 points. Eight of those have come here in the second half. It's 62-56. Oklahoma maintaining a six-point lead. Linwood Davis moving inside as Oklahoma's in the four corners now. Remember, the Sooners have three of their six players that they've used with four fouls. McAllister inside for the easy two. It came easily.
We had the easy basket look like the last time. Didn't get it. This time McAllister converts it. And I think I haven't seen Oklahoma that much go to this spread offense. But under the conditions, I think it's a great, great situation that Billy Tubbs has put his club in right now.
Godbold goes inside and gets his second basket, third basket of the night. And it is now 64-58. Oklahoma by six. 5.5 minutes exactly left to play.
Louisiana Tech, they're just going to pound that ball inside.
Well, Malone just stood aside and let Davis carry it to the hoop.
I think he was anticipating the kickout pass by the little guy right there.
Andy Russo looking on with a lot of concern now as his ball club is down by eight with a little more than 5 minutes to play. And Godbolt now has gotten his fourth basket here in the second half.
He warms up. And you saw Russo there. And I think what he was saying mostly was that Davis was hooking a little bit and getting free.
Godbolt is now 4 out of 13 from the floor, but he was 0 for 3 in the first half. 66-60, Oklahoma, 4:52 remaining to play.
Almost a mistake by Davis right there. He didn't clear or see the man open, just turned and threw the pass, almost got it intercepted. Right now, you know, Louisiana Tech is going to be diving for balls on any passes. You've got to read or maybe even give a check pass in there every once in a while and check the defense out before you release it.
So the Sooners running some clock. 4.5 minutes to play. They're up by six, 66-60. McAllister takes it to the hook, scores for two. McAllister gets two more.
Ellen, they're going to charge the foul on McAllister. He ruled that he released the ball before the foul, so you count two and chalk the foul up to Tim McAllister. But he's been getting good penetration, beating his man, getting inside for the little shot, and he may have got a finger in the eye.
Well, the Sooners playing only six men tonight in the ballgame. David Johnson is the only man who's come off the bench for Oklahoma. There's Wayman Tisdale sitting on the bench with four fouls. He came out at the 9:02 mark, so he's been on the bench for almost 5 minutes. The mailman, Karl Malone. Malone now has 15 points. That breaks a string of four missed free throws in a row by Louisiana Tech after they canned their first 12. Andy Russo taking this Louisiana Tech team as far as any Southland Conference team has ever been, matching the progress made by Lamar to the Sweet 16. Well, Malone's two free throws cut the lead down to six. 4 minutes and 25 seconds to play. There's a timeout on the court. With a score, Oklahoma 68 and Louisiana Tech 62.
You know, when I started dipping Kodiak, made my friend here real happy because it's his brand. Now it's my brand too. It's good and moist with a special cut that packs right, and it's got a big, fresh wintergreen flavor. But don't take my word for it.
I believe was part of our halftime show as well. Paul Galvan, he is a school administrator in North Texas and one of the most respected officials in the country. Paul Galvan. Well, we've got 4:25 remaining to play. It is 68-62, Oklahoma. Sooners with the ball. Now let's see what Louisiana Tech does defensively. Oh, there's a quick steal by Bland for two.
Oh, what a play by Bland. That could turn this game around right now as they cut it back to four.
And a foul on Wayne Smith.
And he's calling a two-shot foul.
An intentional foul on Wayne Smith.
See if we can pick this up. You look at Smith right there. They... going to pressure the ball inbounds. Here's the steal. This is the steal right here. And boy, he picked it clean. Left hand, knocked it away, took it in, and jammed it down.
Well, Linwood Davis is going to go to the free throw line for Oklahoma. And so far this year, 76%, 54 out of 71 for the 5'11 junior from Washington, D.C. And now Tisdale returns after sitting on the bench for about 5 minutes with his four fouls. The All-American, the Olympian from Oklahoma, Wayman Tisdale, back in the ballgame. And Linwood Davis making his first free throw of the night.
Well, if he makes his free throw all the time that Tisdale sat out, they'll just will have broken even. They had a six-point lead when he went out at that nine-minute mark. I think it was 58-52. And now they've got a six-point lead at 70-64.
4 minutes and 9 seconds to play. Oklahoma by six. Winner advances to the Midwest Regional Final on Saturday. Another big shot by Allen Davis, who in the second half alone has hit five baskets. Davis is 6-7 out of 12 now for the night. And it's 70-66. This is a pretty big possession for Oklahoma.
Certainly is. It's a good read by Bowie that time that came up to double-team him. He voided the double-team, just went right over the top with the pass.
And Robert Gottbolt commits the foul, his second. So Oklahoma will go to the line. Now, Oklahoma is a better free throw shooting team statistically than Louisiana Tech, 71% to 65%. But overall, Louisiana Tech has been the more effective of the two tonight. Here is Chu Kennedy. He has 19 points rather than 17. Now has 20. Kennedy about to duplicate his performance of the game in December when he led Oklahoma with 22 points and 15 rebounds. A game that Oklahoma won by 12. And Kennedy now has 21.
Two big free throws right there, step up. He's their second leading scorer and second leading rebounder on the club. Does a great job for 6'5".
The mailman misses. Willie Bland with a rebound and a follow shot. Willie Bland.
Oklahoma afraid to go strong on those boards with that foul trouble, and there's a turnover again as Kennedy just throws it away.
A basket here would make it a two-point ball game with 3:20 remaining. Picked up by Oklahoma. Still a four-point lead with 3:15 to go. 72-68. Big possession again for the Sooners. There's the lob inside. Kennedy can't, won't go. Malone, outlet pass to Wayne Smith. 3 minutes to play. Tip by Smith, won't go. Bland gets it. It's a two-point ball game.
Boy, they're hitting him on the offensive boards right now. They're really crashing. You see Billy Tubbs concerned right now as Oakland with that foul trouble, staying away, not going tough for that ball. But with 2:47 to go, they're going to have to play. I think they're going to have to forget about fouls and go after the basketball.
It's 72-70, Oklahoma by two, with 2:40 remaining to play. Oklahoma's got three players with four fouls. They've used only six players. Here's a steal. A basket here will tie it up. It's 3-on-2. Davis open. We're tied.
What a comeback Virginia Tech, or Louisiana Tech, rather, has made, and it's been their pressure defense. They're really putting the pressure on defensively. If I was Oklahoma, I'd keep the ball away from Bland. Bland has really disrupted their
organization. Oklahoma's called for a timeout. We have a timeout on the court with a score tied at 72. We'll be back at Reunion Arena in just a moment.
It's a good time for the great taste of McDonald's.
It's a good morning and I just can't wait because there's something new I just gotta taste. A fresh baked biscuit's calling to me. A new McDonald's biscuit, bacon, egg, and cheese. Hello there, Ann. You're looking fine, but that sizzling bacon's on my mind. Excuse me, Fred. Can't stop to talk when there's fresh grade A stacked up on top of that new bacon, egg, and cheese biscuit.
And it's a good time for the great taste.
The new taste
of McDonald's.
If you save a dollar on a long-distance call with MCI, don't think of it as a dollar. Think of it as, well, as an ice cream sundae. And if you save $30 a month with MCI, think of it as a new pair of jeans. And if you save $200 a year with MCI, think of it as $200 in the pocket of your new jeans.
Call MCI. Start saving money anytime on all your out-of-state calls. Operators are standing by.
Well, that could be as crucial a statistic as you'll see for the remainder of the ballgame. Remember now, Oklahoma has three more timeouts. Louisiana Tech has two. But Gary, what shooting by the two guards, Willie Bland and Allen Davis. They've gotten five buckets here in the last 2.5 minutes for Louisiana Tech.
Not only the shooting, but the defensive pressure. Bland has been terrific. He's a great defensive player, and you can see why. He stripped the ball one time, stole it down here again, and has given Louisiana Tech life in this ballgame as they've got it back to 72-72.
Oklahoma led this ballgame by 10 points. I'm going to check it for you here in just a moment to see what the last 10-point lead was. I'm not sure what the last 10-point lead was, but in any event, Louisiana Tech has erased the 10-point lead and are now back tied with 2:19 to go.
At one time, Frank, I thought I remember being 52-42 as a 10-point lead that I saw.
Well, and it will be Oklahoma's ball. The Sooners, remember, have got Kennedy, Tisdale, and David Johnson with four fouls. So let's see, all three of the Oklahoma players on the floor that have four fouls are in the ballgame. Kennedy, Tisdale, and David Johnson all playing with four fouls. They're all on the floor right now with 2:19 to go, tied at 72. Johnson to Kennedy. Oklahoma has used only one substitute tonight.
Now Oklahoma with that big lineup in there, they had trouble on the boards with that small lineup and having to lay off because of the foul troubles. But I said, ooh, dangerous pass.
Land almost got the steal. We've got exactly 2 minutes to play. Tied at 72. McAllister to Tisdale on the blocks. Tisdale gets his Sunday shot.
And a good job by McAllister. When he went up for the jump shot, what that does is it freezes the defense. Nobody came to help. He's able to drop it down inside to Tisdale.
A minute 45 remaining. Oklahoma by two. Louisiana Tech with the ball. Davis. Rebounded by Tisdale. A minute 39 to go. Oklahoma with a two-point lead and the ball. This is Bowie. It'll still belong to Oklahoma. Well, let's see Tisdale go over the mailman for this last 2 points.
You see it here. McAllister went up, and the jump shot kind of froze the defense, kept anybody coming to help, and he gets it inside, and when you get it to him down in there deep, it's trouble.
That's 15 points for Tisdale, and here is a foul on Godbolt. That'll put Oklahoma at the line with a minute 31 remaining to play. Robert Godbolt, his third personal foul. Robert has come alive here in the second half. He has 8 points after being shot out in the first half. But now we get David Johnson at the free throw line for Oklahoma.
And Johnson, the poorest free throw on the floor for Oklahoma right there at 60%, and he misses.
Well, a basket here. We'll try it again. We've got a minute 25, as you see in the lower right-hand portion of your screen, remaining to play. Oklahoma 74 and Louisiana Tech 72. Midwest Regionals. There's the lob into Malone. He missed the layup. They missed the alley-oop. They did. Their timing was off. It'll belong to Oklahoma. Somehow the timing was off on that attempt at the alley-oop for Malone.
Yeah, the ball was underthrown, wasn't lobbed quite high enough and too near the basket. I don't really see that you can say he missed that shot. You see it right there. It was right up in the crotch of the basket. He just could not handle it.
Oklahoma with the ball again. They're with a minute 11 to play, and they're going to use one of their three remaining timeouts with a two-point lead. We've got a minute 11, 71 seconds left to play. Timeout with the score, Oklahoma 74 and Louisiana Tech 72.
Get a piece of the power.
Come get it. The lowest interest rate in town. Only 8.8% on any new Nissan truck.
A Nissan Power Machine.
Save over $600 in interest on the regular bed. At only $59.99, it's a great deal. With 8.8, it's even better. See the full line of Nissan trucks. Take your choice. 8.8 could save you up to $1,500 in interest alone. Only from your Nissan Power Team. See Jackie Cooper in Edmond. Frazier on Southeast 74th in Oklahoma City. Ken's in Midwest City. Northwest in Bethany. Wayne Buck in Clinton. And Cannon Dotson in Ponca City.
Nissan Power now!
8.8 for a limited time. Only from your Nissan Power Team. It's awesome.
Get a piece of the power from the Nissan Power Team.
Frank Fallon back with Gary Thompson at Reunion Arena in Dallas. And that right there tells you the whole story, except what's going to happen in the last 71 seconds of the ballgame. Oklahoma, up by 10 on several occasions here in the second half, has succumbed to a furious rally by Louisiana Tech that has seen the Bulldogs tie the ballgame, although they've not been able to go out in front. The mailman, Karl Malone, who has 16 points tonight, but it's really been the shooting of their guards, Allen Davis and Willie Bland, here in the last 5 minutes that have propelled Louisiana Tech back into this ballgame. And Oklahoma now will bring it in with 71 seconds to go. Bowie's going to call. No, he didn't get it. And it now will go over to Louisiana Tech. He tried to call timeout. Hank Nichols said no. The count had reached four. And Louisiana Tech gets the ball with still 71 seconds to go.
Boy, and the defensive pressure is something right here that Louisiana Tech has put on Oklahoma. Watch him. He's counting. I missed the count. So he goes. He tries to turn right there. He does look. Comes back. Comes back right now. And he didn't see him when he originally called the timeout. When he looked back, he may have had that timeout called in time, but the official wasn't looking at it.
Now, what will Louisiana Tech do? Will they go down for one shot and try to tie the ball game, or will they just play it with their guns out of their holsters? Let's see what it is. Wayne Smith, Godbolt. Time remaining, 58 seconds. There are your turnovers. Oklahoma's turned it over 12 times. Louisiana Tech 6. Inside to Godbolt. He misses. And the rebound, Godbolt, and he may have been fouled. I don't think they're going to count the basket. And if it was David Johnson, he is gone. Johnson has committed his foul, his fifth. He becomes the first of the Sooners to foul out of the ballgame with 10 points with 50 seconds left to play.
A good job by Godbolt right there. Missed the shot, but his quickness got him the rebound and took it up. And Johnson, you see, leaving the ballgame, committed the foul. He'll have a chance to go to the line.
Now, Godbolt has not shot a free throw yet tonight, but he is the best free throw shooter on the team. 79.5%. Robert Godbolt, a 6'5 sophomore out of Detroit, the best free throw shooter on the Louisiana Tech team, will be at the line, but he has not had a free throw opportunity yet tonight. If he makes a pair, we're tied again with 50 seconds remaining. And again, Oklahoma uses only a sixth player, Linwood Davis. As the Sooners huddle, David Johnson has fouled out. The only players remaining for Oklahoma are the other five who have played: Kennedy, Bowie, Tisdale, McAllister, and Linwood Davis. And here is Robert Godbolt. 74-72, Oklahoma, 50 seconds to go. Rebounded by Oklahoma. Sooners with the ball, 46 seconds to go. Foul called on Willie Bland with 45 seconds remaining. Well, Louisiana Tech had their best free throw shooter at the line, and Godbolt missed it.
You can't ask for anything more than that, to have your best up there. He just did not get it down, and now Oklahoma has one of their best in Anthony Bowie. In the last 5 minutes of the ball game, he's converted 27 out of 31 free throws in the last 5 minutes. That's almost 88%.
Well, the last representative of the Big Ten has dropped out. Georgia Tech has beaten Illinois 61-53 at Providence, Rhode Island. Tech over Illinois 61-53. That's a final.
Maybe Bowie's biggest 1-1 of the season, and he doesn't convert it. A lot of pressure should come down here.
We've got 41 seconds to go, and who has the basketball? It is going to belong to... Wow, this is a crucial call. Whose ball is it? The officials are conferring.
I thought it looked like it should have been Louisiana Tech's, really.
It will. It'll be the Bulldogs' ball with 37 seconds to go. Oklahoma up by two. Godbolt to Wayne Smith. Now, will they try to get it down low to Malone, or will they shoot it from the perimeter?
I got a feeling they're going to try and get the ball down inside. Oklahoma, that foul trouble first. It doesn't make any difference now. School's out. You've got to play four or not.
Smith is open, but it's a short. Bland with a follow shot. I don't know whether that was planned or not, but Willie Bland got the bucket with 15 seconds to go. It's tied. There's the time remaining. Oklahoma, McAllister to Davis. 8 seconds to go. Davis inside from 12 feet. Missed it. Rebounded by Malone. We're going to overtime.
And they got a crack at it. Puts it up.
Overtime. The score at the end of regulation time, Oklahoma 74 and Louisiana Tech 74. We'll be back for overtime right after this message.
With the spring furniture markets just weeks away, we've cranked up our big spring cleaning sale at Mathis Brothers.
Larry and I have personally authorized our largest discounts of the year on every name brand item in every department at Mathis Brothers.
For example, this classy contemporary dining room set, a good seller at $9.99, is being closed out for just $6.49.
Don't miss out on spring cleaning time at Mathis Brothers, because it means big savings in every department.
We'll be open until 10 every night and Sundays until 7 at 3434 West Reno.
Hey, you're gonna love Taco Mayo. Taco Mayo makes it taste so good. You get it faster, get it fresher. You can't get it any better. Taco Mayo makes it taste so good. Isn't it great at Taco Mayo? Don't you just love that Taco Mayo? Taco Mayo. Taco Mayo. Taco Mayo.
Taco Mayo makes great Mexican food fast.
Well, let's see what's happened as far as the guards are concerned tonight. Louisiana Tech, principally Allen Davis, Willie Bland, and Wayne Smith have outscored Oklahoma on the perimeter, with Davis with 18 and Bland with 14. Oklahoma from the perimeter has only 14 points from its starting guards, but their forwards, Kennedy and Bowie, have more than made up for that.
If you're a Bulldog fan, you ought to be happy going into overtime. The Bulldogs have won their last 8 overtime games.
Is that right?
Last 8 overtime games, they've come away the winner.
Well, they battle back from 10 points down to tie this one and send it into overtime. But now Oklahoma's got big problems with 4 fouls. They've got 2 players on the floor with 4 fouls. Another one, David Johnson, has already fouled out. And now Willie Simmons, who's back in the ballgame, also has 4 fouls for Louisiana Tech. The overtime score, incidentally, is the 6th time that the ballgame has been tied tonight. Tied at 74. Here we go to overtime.
Those foul troubles have really been a problem for Oklahoma, because Louisiana Tech has just been crashing the offensive board. They've been backing off to not commit the foul. And Louisiana Tech, every time they've been missing, they've been able to get it and kick it back in.
Bowie with the ball on the tip. Linwood Davis gets the first quick two. So a quick tip from Bowie to Linwood Davis, and Oklahoma grabs the momentum.
Big advantage always in an overtime game to jump off and get the first basket, get ahead, get that lead early.
As inside, Simmons hook shot wouldn't go. Rebounded by Bland again. Bland with another basket.
Bland has been sensational. He's just been on those offensive boards, grabbing everything that's missed and sticking it back in.
He has scored 10 points since the last 5 minutes of regulation, as Willie Bland, a 6'5 junior from New Orleans. We're tied at 76 in overtime. Tisdale had it stripped away, but he was fouled. And Karl Malone has picked up his 4th foul. So the mailman gets his fourth. He and now the two big men for Louisiana Tech, Simmons and Malone, each have four, while Kennedy and Tisdale each have four for Oklahoma.
Concerned Andy Russo now there as his star, the mailman, picks up his fourth, and both these big guys are looking at Tisdale there, having to come off of their play with foul trouble.
That is only the second free throw in seven attempts tonight, converted successfully by Tisdale. He gets two big ones, however, here in overtime, and Oklahoma's back up by two with 4:20 to go.
Well, I think you call Tisdale a gamer. I've seen him at times, you know, not hit the free throw just like there. When it gets down to game time, he'll hit that clutch free throw.
Wayne Smith. Boy, they're trying to get it to Bland down low. Bland has got the hot hand right now. He and Allen Davis. There's the basket. It's made good again by Willie Bland.
But credit that bucket, I would say, to Malone, because he gave no sooner as that ball touches hands, and boom, he gets it right down on the baseline to Bland, and he's able to make a move before the defense can react and shift.
Willie Bland, as Wayne Smith hits the table over there. Willie Bland came into tonight with an 11-point scoring average. He has scored 20, and 18 of those have come since halftime.
Well, and his high game on the year for Bland is 25, so he's nearing that figure right now.
We're tied at 78 in overtime with 3 minutes and 48 seconds to play. Midwest Regional at Reunion Arena in Dallas. I'm Frank Fallon with Gary Thompson. Here's the pass to Bowie. Tipped away by who else but Willie Bland. Or was it Davis?
That was Davis.
That was Allen Davis that time.
Good recovery. Just quickness save, but could have been a cinch too for Oklahoma.
Score tied at 78. 3 minutes, 46 left to play in overtime.
Don't push! Don't push!
Officials saying don't push to those guys lined up in that stack. Here's Kennedy. Tisdale on the blocks. Malone with four fouls. Can't stop him. It's tipped once, no good. Tipped again. Tisdale has it in his Sunday shot spot. Makes it.
Tisdale just keeping going up with four fouls. He was able to tip the ball, showed his good hands, tipped it away from the defense to recover it on that last time. Finally able to get the shot down.
19 points for Tisdale. Oklahoma by two again. 3:26 to go. Louisiana Tech has not been able to get in front. They've tied the ball game on several occasions. Bland dumps it off to Malone. Malone up over Tisdale. Loose ball on the floor. It will belong to Louisiana Tech. Simmons. Oklahoma's Bowie's got it.
Well, that was a gutsy block down on that end by Tisdale. Blocked the shot again with those four fouls.
We've got 3 minutes to play in overtime. Sooners with the ball and a two-point lead. McAllister inside. Loose ball. Tisdale. Tisdale for two.
Sometimes it's better to be lucky than good. They got a break there, Oklahoma. The ball deflected, fell right into Tisdale's hands.
21 points for Mr. T, and Ellis and Louisiana Tech decides to call for the timeout. And Tisdale has scored 6 points in overtime and has propelled his ball club to a four-point lead with 2 minutes and 47 seconds left to play. All right, let's look at Tisdale against Malone. Meet on meet.
And this may be one of the key ones. I think the game was tied right here when he went up, went in with a little finger roll, couldn't get it. Comes in here, misses a point-blank tip, and then right there, able to tip it once, and he tipped it back on the second time, got his shot off, and made the bucket. And that was a big possession for Oklahoma.
Well, we want to take this opportunity to thank tournament manager Rick Baker, tournament media coordinator Larry White, athletic director Bob Vanetta of Louisiana Tech, head basketball coach Andy Russo and his staff, and sports information director Keith Prince, and from Oklahoma, athletic director Wade Walker, head basketball coach Billy Tubbs and his staff, and sports information director Mike Treps and assistant Kerry Tharp. Transportation arrangements made through Fugazi International Travel, the official travel agency of the 1985 NCAA basketball tournament. Boy, you talk about foul trouble. Look at there. Johnson's gone. Kennedy and Tisdale with four. Simmons and Malone each with four. Eddie Whistle almost sends somebody to the bench, Gary.
That's right. You're in the one-on-one situation. We saw the pressure. If you go down now, Oklahoma will be trying to hang on, and Louisiana Tech trying to come from behind. I thought for a while there, even when Oklahoma was holding them off and getting a two-point advantage, that the momentum was with Louisiana Tech. But Oklahoma has done a great job of fighting it off, and got a key play there on the last basket to extend it to four when they kind of got a lucky break.
Well, Gary, you talked about Tisdale being a gamer. Oklahoma has scored 8 points here in overtime, and six of them by their All-American Wayman Tisdale.
Well, that's exactly what you expect from the All-Americans.
So here we go with 2:47 to go, but don't give up if you're a Louisiana Tech fan. This team battled back from 10 down to send this game into overtime. They're down by four, 2 minutes and 47 seconds to play in OT. Wayne Smith.
I think you got to see Oklahoma just pack way down inside, force him to beat it out, even though Davis was hitting the shot.
Bland didn't get it. Malone with a rebound. Malone off to Bland again.
Good help on defense that time. Forced Malone to take it back out. I thought he was going to take it right up strong.
Here's Malone to the hook for two. It's a two-point ball game. It is Oklahoma 82, Louisiana Tech 80, 2:20 to go.
And Oklahoma seemingly just cannot stop the Bulldogs right now down inside on the board. They just are overpowering Oklahoma.
How in the world could you ask for anything more from a college basketball game than this? Oklahoma up by two. We've got 2 minutes and 5 seconds to play in overtime. We were tied at 74 at the end of regulation. McAllister looking for the lob pass to Tisdale. Can't get it. Double team.
Trouble down there. Turnover country. You take down that baseline, pick up a dribble.
A minute 50 remaining to play right now. It's 82-80 Oklahoma. McAllister from 12 feet. Rebounded by Malone. A basket here will tie it again. Louisiana Tech with a minute and 40 to go. Down by two. Everybody on the Bulldog bench is upstanding. Everybody on the Oklahoma bench is sitting down apprehensively. Louisiana Tech playing right in front of their own bench. A minute 29. You see the time. 82-80, Oklahoma by two. Bland, Malone. Loose ball. It is Oklahoma's Tisdale. A minute 15 to go. Sooners by two with the ball. Kennedy, McAllister. Would not go. Loose ball. Linwood Davis of Oklahoma. 1:05 remaining.
McAllister's had several chances to get easy passes, just cannot convert it, and Oklahoma coming up with a loose ball.
There's Bowie with 56 seconds to go. Bowie hits the basket and puts Oklahoma up by four.
That was great concentration. Godbolt made a good defensive fake at it, but he kept his eyes on the basket, was able to convert, and now Louisiana Tech just converting it right back on him. Not
Malone.
Giving him any breathing room.
That's Malone with 40 seconds to go. It's a two-point Oklahoma lead. They've got a two-on-two break. Bowie! Player control foul on Bowie. As Malone is hurt. Malone goes down hard. We've got 36 seconds to play. It is 84-82 Oklahoma. The ball will belong to Louisiana Tech on the player control foul on Bowie.
Well, the Oklahoma Sooners only seemingly know one way to go, and that's to attack and go at the basket. And you'll see Bowie on this last play just do exactly that. Here comes Malone. Gets shaped up. Comes there. Waits for him. And I think moves a little bit right there. Looks like he might have been moving. But gets called for the offensive foul.
Boy, he really took a charge. Malone moved in and took the charge, and it'll be Louisiana Tech's ball, down by two, 94 feet away from tying it, with 35 seconds to play in the ball game in overtime. We were tied at 74 at the end of regulation. A basket here would tie it. All the cards on the table.
You see Oklahoma. I don't think if I was Oklahoma to extend that far out. They've been so tough and out inside, I'd make them hit the shot outside.
Godbolt missing and a foul inside on one of the Oklahoma players. I believe it may be Linwood, or is it Kennedy?
The way Kennedy's reacting, you see him there in your picture, I think it might be.
Kennedy is gone. He has scored 21 points. He joins David Johnson now on the Oklahoma bench in foul trouble. And Louisiana Tech will again be at the free throw line.
The Oklahoma bench, all the coaches around talking over what they're going to do right now. They've lost Johnson. Now goes Kennedy, their second leading rebounder.
They've got to play somebody who hasn't played in the ball game yet tonight.
That's right.
They've only used six players and two have fouled out. So somebody has got to come in and play with 18 seconds to play who has not been to the ball game so far tonight.
It's going to be a tough situation for them. And if you have to go to a foul, then you're going to look at probably that new player coming in.
Well,
this is what Billy Tubbs has to look at right now as to guess. And I thought maybe Watson might come in, but they're going with Sean Clark.
Sean Clark, a 6'2 junior from Brandywine, Maryland, will come in the ballgame. He becomes only the seventh player used by Oklahoma tonight. And I believe Godbolt is the guy who's going to be at the free throw line, their best free throw shooter, but who missed in the closing moments of regulation play at the free throw line.
I think going with Clark right here, I was looking at Watson to come in. It was a little bit bigger on the boards, but Oklahoma's going to get the ball on offense. They'll have a better ball handler in the ball game than Sean Clark.
Well, the Sooners are going to call for a timeout, Gary, to talk it over. I believe they have, let's see, they got one additional timeout, so I think Oklahoma has two timeouts left, and I believe Louisiana Tech has three. We'll check that, but I think that's the way it remains with 18 seconds. Is that the way you have it?
Well, I had it two for Tech. But I'm not sure. We're not official. We'll have to check that out, see if we get...
Well, they do each get one additional in overtime.
Right.
And I think it was two and three. I think it's two apiece right now. We'll see in any event. Watch Kennedy now after Chu Kennedy fouled out of this ball game a moment ago.
Well, there's emotions galore by both clubs, and you see him right now. He knows he's gone, and that's what hurts us to have to leave the ball game. He knows how valuable he is to this Sooner ball club.
He has scored 21 points, the same number as Wayman Tisdale. And we've got 18 seconds left in OT. We were tied at 74. Kind of interesting that the first ball game, Oklahoma won by an 84-72 count. They've got 84 right now, but the other side has 10 more than 72.
Well, it's just been a tremendous basketball game, and now we got officially that each team has two timeouts.
Two timeouts remaining for each team. This is a battle between the Oklahoma Sooners, rated number 4 in the nation, and Louisiana Tech, rated number 8 in the nation. And it has been everything we expected it to be and a little bit more.
You have to think Louisiana Tech would love to get in an overtime. With the foul problems with Oklahoma and have lost two of their key players, they should be in a real advantageous position.
There are those two timeouts apiece, and Robert Godbolt, the 6'5 sophomore out of Detroit, 79.5% free throw shooter, the best on the ball club, but he missed, and he's shooting two here now. It is now a one-point ball game, and Godbolt can tie it for, I believe, the 11th time tonight with this free throw.
Getting the two free throws helps, relieves a little bit of that pressure, knowing you have to get the first one down, and he threads both of them.
Godbolt ties it with 18 seconds to play in overtime. It is 84 apiece. Now Oklahoma will have one shot. And there's the time left in overtime. Sooners and Bulldogs tied at 84.
McAllister's been looking for that shot. He has not been able to hit it. But
they want to get it to Tisdale, down on the blocks. He got it.
Roger.
2 seconds left. Louisiana Tech has called timeout with 2 seconds left. That ball hung on the rim for a full 3 seconds before it fell through.
You just took the words out of my mouth at a time. That's probably the most important about that basket going in, was it hung there and took time off the clock. Because I looked up, and there was 5 seconds about that ball was hanging around there, and it went down to 2 seconds on the clock. Watch Tisdale right now. It goes up. Looked like it might have even got tipped a little bit, but hangs, bounces around. And the count hangs there again, and all of, meanwhile, the clock is running off.
Oh, that is great camera work. That is super camera work.
And look at the clock down low. Let's see now. There it goes. Goes up with a shot at 5. That's when I looked, and it hangs 4, 3, 2 down. And you got to say, the officials are right on that call to give the timeout, because they've got it with 2 seconds.
And are those Oklahoma Sooners happy? But they can't celebrate yet, because Louisiana Tech, a gutsy ball club with 2 seconds to go, is not out of it. It's 86-84 Oklahoma. Tisdale, incidentally, has scored 8 points here in the overtime period. 8 of the 12 points that Oklahoma has in overtime, Wayman Tisdale has scored.
Well, and in the game that they won at Tulsa, he scored 12 of the last 14 points in that ball game.
Tisdale has a total of 23. He had only 6 at half, and has scored 8 of the 12 for Oklahoma here in overtime, including that basket with 2 seconds to play that puts him up by 2, 86-84.
You got to look. I got to think that Louisiana Tech, one of two things. They got to look to throw a long down court, or maybe get a long set up something where they can get a pass to midcourt, call timeout immediately, and I'd alert the officials to that if that's what I was going to do, and then try and inbounds, get a shot up with 1 second. If I'm Oklahoma right now, I'm going to put a guy on the ball inbounds and make it tough to get it in. But I think they're going to, their show dropping back.
The clock will start when somebody touches the ball inbounds. There are 2 seconds. Of course, it could be a mini two. It could be just a fraction under. Here's the pass to Malone. Malone to Wayne Smith. Timeout. They called. No, they didn't get it. Wait a minute. Did they or not? Did they or not? The clock shows zero, but Wayne Smith is saying, and I believe the officials may be going to put 1 second back on the clock. I think they're going to put 1 second back on the clock, and Oklahoma and Louisiana Tech got the ball in the forecourt.
I like to put a man on the ball right there so he can't easily throw the ball down. Watch it right now. We got the count. There's the clock in the corner.
Doesn't start till somebody touches the ball.
Okay,
now it starts.
Now starts. He kicks it off one, and he calls timeout.
Yeah, he got it. He clearly got it. He clearly got it with 1 second to play.
Just ahead of it, turning double zero.
Now, Gary, now that they're in the forecourt, they can throw the pass down closer to the basket. You assume probably to Malone to try to get the shot at the buzzer, but he's got to hit it the minute he gets the ball.
Well, and the thing right now is that resetting the clock back to the one, you're going to get a full 1 second count right now. Had that happened in between, you might have got a half a second, even though one shows on the clock. So that's a key play right there. And it's a gamble what you're going to do. You're going to throw it up again, Louisiana Tech. Maybe they'll try and run somebody in from behind and throw a lob to the basket. And, of course, Oklahoma has got to back off, worry about the foul.
Well, the only people who apparently are not limp here at Reunion Arena are the cheerleaders from Oklahoma and Louisiana Tech.
Well, again, I think I'm going to, if I'm setting up, I think I've got to put a man, a big man on that ball and make it tough to make this pass. I just can't make a point-blank pass.
Oklahoma is the only team this year that has scored more than 74 points on Louisiana Tech, and they've done it twice now. It's 86-84 with one full second to play in overtime. The Bulldogs, the champions of the Southland Conference, will have the ball in forecourt with 1 second, which means the second the guy inbounds touches the ball, he's got to shoot it.
And this is what college basketball is all about. It's the greatest game going.
You cannot match this kind of excitement. All right, Godbolt will be the trigger man.
They've got Watson up there right now. He needs to get up, wave, jump, anything to let that kid make a good pass.
Chuck Watson, a 6'7 sophomore. There's the lob. Here's the try. They tried to tip it. It did not go. It's all over. They didn't get the play away, and Oklahoma has won it by a score of 86-84. And advances to the finals of the Midwest Regionals on Saturday. Play either.